The following is a special presentation of the National Lacrosse League.
Buffalo has won 5 games in a row and averaged 14 goals per game during that streak. Toronto is on just a 1-game winning streak because their game before that was a loss in Buffalo. The North Division may be brand new to the NLL, but there's nothing new to the rivalry between the Bandits and the Rock. The rivalry resumes this afternoon on BR Live. Welcome to the Buffalo Bandits at the Toronto Rock. I'm Stephen Stampy's Brian Shanahan. Shanny, it's always big when it's Bandits Rock.
Yeah, you know, it doesn't matter where these teams are in the standings. They're always great games. But right now, these two teams are both fighting for important positioning in the North Division.
We're looking at some key players to watch. We're starting with the visiting Bandits, and it's hard not to go with Dane Smith.
Yeah, you know what? He's in his 7th season in the NLL. Since his 3rd season, he's been a consistent 100-point guy. You know, if it wasn't for an injury a few years ago, this would be going for his 6th straight year of 100 points. In fact, he holds a record of 137 points one season, 72 goals, and he's on pace to break the assist record this year. But he is the leader offensively, very dynamic.
A lot of guys for Buffalo doing good things, but nobody's had bigger goals for the last few games for them than Corey Small.
Yeah, I really think throughout his career he scores clutch goals. Last year he scored the goal to put it in overtime in the championship game. They lost in overtime, but yeah, they 2 overtime games in the last few weeks. He has scored the winner. He's a great shooter, especially when they really need it.
On the other side of the ledger, for Toronto, it's the Dueling Dans, our players to watch. One has been there forever, it seems, Dan Dawson.
Yeah, Dan Dawson, his 19th season. This guy does it all. He's just one assist away from reaching 900. Only 2 other guys have that. But it's not just what he does as far as the points. Last week, when it seemed that Halifax was coming back late in that game, Dawson shorthanded, took the ball to the net, drew a penalty. That took all the pressure off, gave Toronto the important win. He just does whatever it takes to win, whether it's scoring, setting up, or big picks.
And I thought when he was mic'd up, it was the best segment of the year.
Yeah, he's another coach.
The other Dan is Dan Craig, who's coming back to the roster.
Yeah, he didn't play last week. You know, he's only in his 3rd year for the Toronto Rock, 3rd year in the NLL, but he's become the most dangerous weapon from the lefties with Adam Jones out right now. He's scoring some big goals. He's the 3rd leading scorer, even though he missed a game. But, yeah, this guy is on pace to have his best season. He had 20 goals last year. He's on pace for about 27 this year.
The 3rd member of our team is Ashley Docking, and she spoke to the coaches.
Thank you so much, guys. Now listen, both of these teams are coming in here with a ton of confidence. Of course, the Rock have won 4 of their last 5. For the Bandits, they're on a 5-game heater. But for Buffalo, 2 of their last 3 games, as you guys mentioned, going into overtime. So although head coach John Tavares knows that there's so much parity in the league, so it's tough to secure a blowout win, he says it is important to continue to put pressure on when your team is playing with a lead.
No, I think that's easier said than done. I think all the teams are very competitive in the league, and anybody can beat anyone on any given night. So we've had the lead a few times at half, 7-3, 7-4, where you kind of feel like you control, especially the last couple of games with the exception of this past weekend. We've blown a few leads and just kind of snuck by in overtime. And, you know, we just got to learn to play complete 60 minutes and not get complacent. You know, it's definitely something you want to see. When you have a 5-goal lead, you want to maintain it. But of course, these teams that we're playing are very competitive, and they're going to come back, and no one's going to quit.
As for the Rock, there's no shortage of confidence on that bench, and it's not like the win against Halifax added confidence, because they've always been really sure of themselves and the guys in that locker room. What Matt Sawyer did tell me that he's looking for today, though, is for their offense to get the Buffalo defense moving a little bit more. As you remember, they only were able to score 8 goals against Buffalo in their last meeting.
You know, that's something we want to do against any defense. But you know, they got a real good goaltender, one of the best in the game behind them. And you know, you want to try to open up some lanes, find a way to get to the net. And you know, if we're just down there and we're stale and we're stagnant on the outside, it just plays into their hand and makes it easier for both their goalies and their defense.
And Matt Sawyer, of course, is going to be our mic'd up person of the game. Of course, we don't have any pregame sound from him, so hoping to get some gems a little bit later on in the broadcast. Quick IR news for you. It's going to be Adam Jones still, Tom Schreiber, Latrell Harris, who are all in the IR. They had been before. Brandon Slade added to that group for Buffalo. No Steve Priolo, no Nick Weiss for them on the back end today. We have face-off coming up very shortly. This is the NLL on BR Live. We hope you stick with us. See you in a bit.
The NLL on BR Live is brought to you by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit geico.com to see how much you could save. And by Alterna Savings, Alterna offers easy, more personal financial services and puts the good in banking. Visit alterna.ca to learn more.
Hello, lacrosse friends. Welcome to NLL action on BR Live. I am Stephen Stamp, joined by Brian Shanahan. Just filling in today for Andy McNamara, who's off on a little family vacation, but very exciting game to be coming in for the great Bandits Rock rivalry.
Yeah, every time these teams play, we get some excitement, and there's always a bit of hate between these two teams.
We're going to take a look at the starting goaltenders for this game, Shanny.
Well, Matt Vince starting for the Buffalo Bandits. No surprise there. I think John Tavares was trying to give me a little misinformation when he said he might start bucking, but you know they're going Matt Vince. He's a legend already, future Hall of Famer.
Seven-time goalie of the year in the NLL. And at the other end of the floor, a guy everyone here is very familiar with.
Yeah, and I was actually surprised when I saw this is his 63rd consecutive start for the Toronto Rock. And coming off one of his best games last week, the 12-9 victory over the undefeated Halifax at the time. And Nick Rose is having a great season.
Buffalo Bandits are fans of the Rock last week, beating Halifax, as that allowed Buffalo by winning on Friday night to move into a tie for Halifax.
Both at 6-1 right now. Yeah. Toronto would like to ruin that record today.
Let's take a look at the keys to the game, starting with the Bandits.
Well, they want to stay out of the penalty box, play 5-on-5 lacrosse, and they don't want Toronto to dictate pace, especially since Buffalo has just played in Vancouver Friday, a lot of travel yesterday. They don't want it to be a run-and-gun game.
Yeah, the Bandits would like to bleed the clock a little, maybe, as you're running the football.
Exactly. And from Toronto's perspective, you know, pretty much the same as last week. They want to get their offense inside the Buffalo defense, and that's very difficult to do because they play a tight pack defense. They also want to play fast all over the floor. That's transition, offense, defense. They've had a lot of success this year doing that.
We are just about ready to go. Big game, big meaning. Especially with the playoff format now, with the top two in each division, first place team gets a top three seed, second place team gets a 4-6, and then if you're not first or second, you got to be looking for a wild card.
Yeah, exactly. It's not that you can't make the playoffs with a third place, but you're assured of it if you're the first two places. And right now, yeah, you've got two teams in the North Division at 6-1, so there's work to be done for the Toronto Rock.
Ian McKay for Buffalo in their white with the orange trim going left to right. Mitch Gustafson for Toronto in the blue with the red trim going right to left, but it's Buffalo that gets first possession, and Justin Martin will take the ball, hand it off eventually to the offense, taking his time, gets it over to Chase Fraser, the dynamic one, comes to the near side to Corey Small. There is Garrett Billings, the new addition recently, and there's Fraser spinning, shooting off the post. The first one gets by Rose, but it goes back straight to Dane Smith. Buffalo setting back up. Ball goes far side. There's Billings. Double team. Leaves Smith for a moment, but nice job by Burns to jump on him. The ball's wide. Taylor Stewart in his first game with the Rock, just acquired from the Colorado Mammoth for a second round pick. I like that addition. Here comes Dan Dawson. The venerable Dan Dawson hands it off to Hellyer. Craig, who's back in the lineup after missing the last game, hands it off. Palace gives it back to him. Buffalo staying pretty tight on everybody so far. Here's a chance to Craig driving to the net. He's stripped by Gilray, and the 30's going to expire.
Yeah, we mentioned that the injured players a while ago. Captain Dan Priolo is not playing for the Buffalo Bandits, neither is Nick Weiss, but Buffalo has not played well without Priolo in the lineup. Other than Friday night, they got the win, but the 1.5 games he's missed so far, Buffalo has not looked good.
Josh Byrne getting checked very tightly there by David Brock. They're well aware of what Byrne can do. Here's Kaluche, had a huge game last week, gets to the net. That one's blocked out front though by Damon Edwards. Goes straight to Dane Smith, out of the frying pan, into the fire, but Rose makes the save. Here's Byrne to rip one, another save by Rose. He's sharp early.
That's three big saves within about 15 seconds. Get a lot of weapons offensively for Buffalo. You know, adding a guy like Garrett Billings really helps you, and I don't think he's at his game yet, but sooner or later it'll come.
Yeah, Billings clearly easing into the lineup, getting a feel for everybody, but they have plenty of weapons. The last thing the opponents want for them is to get some more. Here comes Dawson to the net, shoots it, 5-hole scores. Cam Dawson, loves seeing him drive the net.
How did he squeeze that in? And Dawson, you see the value of him pick up with, you know, Schreiber and Jones out, and Dawson has just assumed such an important role. And it just squeezes it short side. I don't know if Vince thought with Dawson's reach that he was going to come around. That looked like one Vince should have had.
Yeah, it didn't seem like a lot of space for Dawson, but he found it. I mean, he's made a career of doing that. He's also very close to a career milestone in assists.
Yeah, he's got 899. One more assist will give him 900, and he'd be just the third player with 900 assists. Number one and two, Buffalo coach John Tavares. And then number two is Josh Sanderson, who you guys are very familiar with.
Rob Hellyer also nearing a career milestone. We'll get to that later. He rips one that's stopped by Vince, and he pounces on that rebound. And let's go down to Ashley Docking on the floor.
Yeah, thanks so much, you guys. It's time for the BetMGM inactive report for Buffalo. We have no Dallas Bridal. We have no Quinn Palace. And then on the side of the Toronto Rock, Alex Toulé sitting this one out, as is Jameson Dilks.
All right, thanks, Ashley.
Dilks played his first game last week, and, you know, I said I didn't really notice him. And some of his teammates have said that means he played a great game, and I agree with that. When you're playing defense, you don't get noticed, you're playing a great game.
David Brock and Billy Hostrazer have both stayed up to play offense on this shift for Toronto. Craig will hand it off to Dawson, the regular righty forward. Another shot to the far side. Now he's gone through the crease. Couldn't play the ball or really check McKay, but Buffalo gets it anyway. Here comes Brownell. Buffalo or Toronto with just two regular forward righty forwards, Dawson and Hellyer, dressed today. So we expect Challen Rogers to play up a lot, as he's been doing. Here's Byrne cutting through the middle. He's taken down. Great defense. What a job by Cree and Adam Jay, who's just a burgeoning young player. Here's Burns, feeds it through, nice, goes in. Just gonna say nice save, but a great shot to tuck it home. What a finish.
And this is the formula the Toronto Rock was using last week. Push the ball on offense all the time. And you see this develops a nice turnover. That ball gets knocked loose, Toronto gets it. It turns into a 3-on-2. Gustafson starts it, throws the ball up, and again, short side just squeezes it past Vince.
What great timing on the pass to feed it through to Josh Neubenville at the perfect moment. There's so many of these Toronto defenders that we could say the same thing about. Young players, athletic, and really just improving rapidly.
Yeah, you know, Toronto's got the kind of defense where it's not just one guy who's got the green light. They all do it, and many of these guys that play defense have very good hands offensively.
Big scrum right in front of Ashley, and she is holding up her clipboard very astutely to make sure she's safe. And where play is back in, Kevin Brownell will take it. He's going to hand it off and go to the bench. Handing it off there to Garrett Billings.
That was Juvenile's second goal of the season.
Dane Smith with a low shot, stopped by Rose. Smith all over the defender, I think. Yeah, he stepped back into the crease.
Yeah.
That was Scott Dominey. Did a quick word for the officials, but they were absolutely on that one. He did definitely step in. Here's Keeley. Pass across to the near side to Keeley. He rips one, that's a little bit wide. Dane Smith trying to decoy, but Stewart ties him up, loses his helmet for his troubles. Here comes Toronto, it's a 2-on-2. Now 2-on-3, David Brock shoots. Oh, and Vincent's save goes straight out to Dominey, but he is swarmed by white jerseys. Brock tries to help out. Noseworthy back in the defensive end is going to pick up that loose ball. He's been playing up front a fair bit for Buffalo as they've needed him.
Yeah, you know, and it might not have been a great shot by Brock, but that's what Toronto's been doing, though. They're taking those shots if they get them.
Cloutier takes a shot, gets his own rebound, but it's knocked away from him. Nice heads-up play by Brad Cree, the face-off man.
Fantastic play by Cree. Do you see the way he just boxed him out? I mean, and that's something that guys learn when they go to the NLL. You got to be careful when there's a loose ball not to just put your eyes on the ball. You got to make sure the man is not picking it up.
Here's the pass to the trailer. Comes back to the near side to Hellyer. Hard off the crossbar. No over and back. And a fresh 30 for the Rock when they pick this one up.
The last time these teams played each other, Hellyer scored 5 goals on Vince, and it seemed like every shot that he took was finding the back of the net.
Here's Challen Rogers up for the offensive shift. Tries to drive by McKay. Goes far side. Reed Reinhold. One hand whip pass up to Rogers to Hellyer. Stepping back, looking for the pass to the far side. Couldn't find anyone. Reinhold tried to grab it there. Down to 8 on the shot clock. Gets it to Hellyer. And that's headed out of play. We're going to go to our first break. This is the NLL on BR Live. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan. 2-0 Rock over the Bandits so far. We'll be right back. Next weekend, the NLL Game of the Week moves right here to Toronto as Rob Hellyer and the Rock play host to Mitch Jones and the Warriors. Catch all the action on BR Live, Twitter, and Facebook starting at 7 p.m. Eastern. We are ready to roll once again. 2-0 Rock, just under 6 minutes in, and quick start for this Toronto side, Shanny.
Yeah, it sure is, but having known the way these two teams play each other, it really means nothing. I don't think any of these teams get too excited when they go up by 2 or 3 goals against each other because they know how it can change so quickly.
Starting with the man who gets the ball to start this possession, Dane Smith, doing so much for Buffalo. I think he's having a great year. He had a career high with 70 assists last season, but I feel like his assists have been a little more impactful this year. Last year he seemed to get a few more. They're just kind of in the flow of play. He has been dynamite with passes like that to Corey Small. And that one's off the post. It was almost another Smith for Smith. Almost another goal for Small. The Rock are going to come up with it under pressure from Keeley, but Hostrozer gets the ball. Oh, they throw it almost away.
Getting that ball over the line.
Well, and now Manns is trapped. Harnett dives in there. Spanger, and Toronto does get it, but Brock is swarmed and doesn't have anywhere to go, or does he? Swims through trouble, gets it back. 8 to shoot. Toronto's going to have to try and get one off quickly. And they will. A rip by Manns, but it bounces off the backboards. Straight out to Marcus Minichiello. He's going to run in transition. Hands it off to Dane Smith. Couple of righties over on the lefty side. And that pass doesn't connect. Nick Rose grabs it. Here come the Rock back the other way.
Oh, boy.
Oh, yeah. That was floating up there for Gustafson, and Byrne was closing in. Ian McKay swooped in to take it. Bandits setting up. We get it to the top to Small. There's Smith, watched by Jubinville, getting some help from Jay. McKay picks that one up off the backboards. They're down to 10 seconds to shoot. Step around by Fraser. Oh, he had the man to snoo right on top of the crease, but couldn't quite connect with it. Rock come back the other way. Hostrozer gets it across center, and they will set up in the offensive zone. Craig out of the boards, gets to Rogers, and here is the dangerous one. Dan Craig down the alley. Buffalo keeping them to the outside at this point. Dawson flips it back, and Rogers tried the toe drag to cut through, but he lost it, and the 30 expires. Good defensive shift by Buffalo there, Shanny.
Yeah, notice Buffalo's playing packed in. They're giving the outside shot, but not letting Toronto get inside.
I mean, with guys like Zach Manns, Challen Rogers, that outside shot can be dangerous, but obviously Vince feels pretty comfortable with those. He's stopped a lot. Here's Byrne going to the net. That's a nice save by Rose, and then Byrne lands in the crease. That is one of the most dangerous shots in lacrosse right now, is the Josh Byrne crease jump. Ripped by Edwards on the other end. And here comes McKay. He's got two men with him, including the trailer. McKay shoots, foot save, Nick Rose. He is sharp.
That's a nice save. That's a good shot to the short side. Very difficult. Good save by Rose.
I was looking at the trailer thinking the Toronto defender had come and was taking McKay. I think the Toronto defender might have seen what I saw and kind of backed off, and McKay wisely takes the shot, but a great save by Rose. Keeley hands it off. Comes over to Dane Smith. Gets to Small, reaches around with the save again. Rose is seeing the ball very well. Host Roger pushes it. Finds the trailer.
It says Buffalo's only got seven shots, but they've got some good quality shots.
Yeah. Of those seven, probably six are pretty good ones. And there's a rip. Speaking of good shots, Robbie Hellyer with the laser high-to-high.
Hellyer, he's just made a career of doing that. And, you know, sometimes you see Hellyer earlier in the game missing on that top corner, but he seems to hone in as the game goes along, and it hasn't taken him long to find. That's a perfect shot. Using the defender as a screen, just backs off. He's one of the best in the NLL, taking that outside shot, you know, with the defender on him.
And that step back shot where you, as the forward, you just establish the contact and lean in and then step back. It's so hard for
Adam,
the defender.
Adam Jones does the exact same thing on the other side.
I actually wrote about an IL Indoor last week about a bunch of different things. One was Sean Evans using that shot. He didn't start it with the back to the net as well. Here's Dominique trying to catch the ball. Just gets away from him on the pass. Ahead here comes DeSnew looking the other way for Buffalo. They're going to slow it down. Josh Byrne will take it. Byrne with seven goals a couple weeks ago in that overtime win in Colorado. Here comes Garrett Billings. Kluche starts to drive to the net, stripped by Creed, but it bounces straight back to him. Byrne, hard rip, Smith's open, trying one more pass to Kluche, and he just missed it. Well, Creed lost track of Kluche for a moment, but he stepped in the crease. I think Rose made the save anyway.
Pretty good play by Kluche to drive to the net. He's a big guy. When he gets his shoulder down and tries to go to the net, he's tough to stop.
Hellyer started to go to the net. Looked like he was going to make a pass. Sweeting gets on him. It's knocked loose. Sweeting's lost his stick. He's just kind of mucking about. Vince trying to dig in there and get the ball. There's six guys in that scrum.
Yeah, you said it. They're mucking about. Buffalo is just making sure Toronto doesn't get it.
It was Hellyer that had lost his stick. All right, this game is flying by. It's 3-0 Rock. We have 4:42 to go here in the first quarter. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan. This is the NLL on BR Live. We'll be right back. The Rock have some fun theme nights coming up this season, starting with Rob Hellyer bobblehead next Saturday, followed by Kids Day, Charity Game, and 90s Night approaching in March. Visit torontorock.com to see the full schedule and buy your tickets today. 3-0 Rock. Dane Smith, once again, this is just like the start of the last break. Dane Smith with the ball down to our left, running ahead. The Bandits scoreless so far, but not worried, right?
No, I don't think so.
We have, as Ashley mentioned earlier, we have Matt Sawyer, the head coach of the Rock, mic'd up. So we're going to pick up some sounds from him through the course of the game. Looking forward to that.
Yeah, that's been some great stuff.
Okay, here we go. And we're going to go to Ashley right now.
Yeah, thanks so much, you guys. Talking to Sheldon Burns before the game, he mentioned how much success they had against Halifax in transition because their group is extremely athletic, so they want to stay committed to that. He noted that Buffalo have some guys that are slower to get off the floor on the offensive end, so the opportunity to push it in transition is there, as we see right now.
Here's Damon Edwards, perfect timing, but he rams it off the post. That's three posts now, I believe. Well, four posts between the two teams.
Good timing from Ashley there to talk about how good Toronto's been on transition.
I don't know how she organized that to make sure there was a transition break just as she finished talking about it.
Dane Smith broke her stick in half on that last shift too.
Yeah, and then there was a moving pick. Pretty aggressive one by Chase Fraser. Here's a chance for Rogers flipping it up to Palace. It gets away from him. This dude trying to fight through, and that's going to be a little loose ball push in the back. Almost a loose ball grab on the shoulder.
It was actually worth it from Toronto's perspective because if Buffalo had picked up that ball cleanly, they were going on a fast break.
100%. Dane Smith driving in. Rogers turns him aside. Boy, that's a lot of talent right there and athleticism.
New stick in his hand already.
Got a pretty sweet head on that one.
Now, those are the kind of passes that Billings makes work. He didn't make it work there.
Jay on the run, finds the man off the bench, Dan Craig. Big save by Vince. And I know it's only three, you know, only 11 and a half minutes into the game, but it feels like a big save because as much as Buffalo doesn't worry about getting down, you don't want to fall too far behind.
Chase Fraser, Fraser went down on that last play. If I'm not mistaken, it looked like he was limping a little bit when he went off. You don't want to lose him.
Yeah, he just got back to the bench after trailing back. Here's Kluche, toe drag to duck through Cree, but Cree knocks it loose. It does go back to McKay. Smith will rip it. That's well off the mark. It's going to come out to McKay, and he'll just pat it forward as the 30 was expiring. Is he picked up by Challen Rogers? Oh, sorry, that is... That's Brad Cree throwing it ahead, and Dan Dawson finds Hellyer. Far side, Craig hands it off.
Easy.
Across the top for Manz, he passes it. Dawson, quick movement. You talked about the Rock, want to play quick, want to play fast. They are moving the ball, they're moving their feet. To Snoo, trail checks, Hellyer shot. Great job to fight through the check and get the shot off.
Oh, nice play, and he just stepped around. Just knew he made it look like he was standing still.
Nicchiello leaves it for Byrne. Byrne taking his time as they wait for Billings to get out. That pass is a stray though. And here comes Adam Jay. That was a great check. We're not going to see one of Adam Jay's spectacular goals that have become his specialty for the Rock. He's another one of those good young athletic defenders. Rogers. John Harnett, the veteran, meets him. Big pick from Stewart. Taylor Stewart, that's a back end. Taylor Stewart, not really a stranger to playing up front. He played for the U.S. at the Worlds last year. I actually saw him in a tournament fall of 2018 at the last night. He was playing quite a bit of forward. He's not bad. He's
up front.
Here comes Hellyer. One hand. Gets some swats. There's a shot by Palace. Vince swallows that one up. There's a man up the floor. McKay. Great pivot, shoot, scores! What a catch off a great pass and a lovely finish.
Yeah, a nice play by Ian McKay, the second-year player, had a great rookie year for Buffalo last year. Smartly snuck up the floor when he saw his team was getting the ball. You say way up the floor, but that's a perfect pass by Vince. His second scoring chance. Rose made a nice toe save earlier on him this time. Instead of going low, he goes for the top corner and puts it in.
And I'm always impressed with goalies. One of the keys there is Matt Vince, as he rakes the ball to himself, and as he's lifting up, he's looking to see where he's going to go. That's why he knew McKay was there and had the time to get it to him. Great start. Noseworthy comes in for the faceoff against Gustafson on this one. Matt Gilray swoops in, but it's swatted away from him. There's a chance for Stewart. He is double-teamed, rammed into the bench, and I think the ball fell out into the Buffalo bench.
Mitch Gustafson picked up his first career NLL point. Today he got an assist on that Jubinville goal.
So Buffalo's going to get possession. As it went off of the Toronto player, here comes Kluche. Bandits on the board, would love to close it up before the end of the quarter here. Byrne, warding off with that one hand, swims underneath. Oh, that
so
is a
good.
Great play. Was that too active with the hand?
I'm telling you, I think he is. Him and Curtis Dixon, when you get on the crease, they are two of the toughest guys to stop. And somebody was telling me, they said, you always think he's in the crease illegally when he scores until you watch it on replay. And yeah, lots of air.
We talked about it before the game. He flies so far. He landed past the goal line.
Yeah.
He is right on top of the goal line. How do you stop that? I actually had Josh Byrne on Box Street, my podcast. You can find it on Apple Podcasts, SoundCloud, wherever you get your podcast. And he said, I asked him about the crease jumps, and said, you know, Callum Crawford really popularized it. And he credited Crawford because they were teammates here in Buffalo for a while.
Well,
he said
right,
he learned a lot. Crawford really mentored him. And I think Byrne may have even taken it to another level, but I think Byrne and Crawford are probably the two of the best at the jump. Curtis Dixon with the crease dive. There's Small, tries the quick stick, it gets away from him. That's going to be an illegal push. If the ball was caught, it would have been okay, but it got away from him, so Hostrauser's push wasn't allowed. Smith running through a check, hands it off to Small. They find Billings. He's going to get one, a rip. Right back to Dean Smith. He tried to tennis racket it. He can't believe he missed that net. There was a lot of net to shoot at. Keeley gets it back. Such an athletic forward. He hasn't shown yet really in the NLL what he can do, but 2 years ago he played 5 Arena Lacrosse League games, scored 9.2 points a game. he's pretty
not
talented.
Too shabby.
Byrne faced the flip back to Keeley and goes to Dane Smith, but it's tipped away by Brad Cree. Another caught turnover by Cree. He's one of the leaders. He's going to try and get a shot off. Oh, protected the ball very well, but Vince makes the stop. Byrne. Vince going to the bench as there's only a second to go in the quarter. They didn't get the extra man out. They got a shot, though. But through 15 minutes, we are 3-2 for Toronto. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan. Thanks for being with us here as you see the NLL on BR Live.
Welcome back to Scotiabank Arena. I'm joined by Blaine Manning, assistant coach for the Toronto Rock. Now, it feels to me like you guys have a pretty good handle on this game. Is that the sense with you guys on the bench?
Not really. We're in control. We're just sloppy. A lot of unforced turnovers. They played a couple nights ago and had to fly across the country. We probably could have been off to a better start, but we're into a game. We're always going to be with these guys.
What's the difficulty between preaching patience on the offensive end and then fighting against the shot clock, which you guys have done a couple times in the first?
Yeah, it's certainly a fine line. Sometimes you want to play fast against these guys, and sometimes you want to settle it down and grind them 5-on-5. It just almost seems like it's a real-time decision, kind of what presents itself. But we'll just hopefully make smart decisions here and keep moving.
Thanks, Coach.
Thanks.
Back to you guys.
Thanks, Ashley. I like the questions Ashley asks. That's a good question about the balance between patience and making sure you're not getting rushed at the end of the shot clock.
No, you're right. And Blaine also made the point about Buffalo playing on Friday and traveling. Mm. And it's interesting. I think Graham Perot, who does a lot of writing for NLL Insider, he wrote an article about teams traveling and, playing back-to-back against the rest of the team. And surprisingly, playing back-to-back doesn't really hurt. I think statistically they're about 500, the teams that have played back-to-back, even though they're playing the rest of the team. Although he did say traveling does sort of tip the scales a little bit in favor of the rest of the team. Because that's not just a regular road trip, that's a Vancouver road trip. But these guys were traveling all day long yesterday.
Yeah, but it is the day off, which helps, right?
I mean,
it's when you do the Friday night and come back for Saturday.
But it's not nearly as bad as you would think it is. You'd think the rest of the team would always be getting the win, and that just doesn't happen.
I think back-to-back teams are actually above 500 in those situations over the last number of years. I'd have to go double-check. Here's Taylor Stewart playing an offensive shift, as we talked about earlier. Passes across to Hellyer. Circling the top, gets a shot from his offside. Vince turns to the side with the hand. Minichiello is there. Two men on him. He gets it out. Nice play by the rookie. But then the pass gets away from Brownell. Mitch Desnoux, who's upset that he didn't connect on the pass, goes to check, but Toronto comes up with it. Brad Cree grabs the ball. Hellyer whips it down to Dawson. He's one-on-one with Barton. That is not good for any defender. Passes it to Palace. Fakes backhand, goes forehand. Just missed. Brownell picks it up. Brownell along the near boards. Dane Smith's going to go. I thought he was going to send a pick. He's going to go into the open and take the pass now. Up to Cloutier, fifth man off the bench. Rips it high and hard, but a little too high. And maybe here's a break. A chance for Dominey. He's called over and back. He was trying to get after that ball.
I think that once the referee saw that he wasn't going to pick it up cleanly and get a breakaway, he blew the whistle. Otherwise, you might have had a collision between him and Vince.
Nobody wants that. Hellyer to Manns on the near side. Nice seal from Palace, but the shot was blocked. Comes straight back to him. Matt Gilray all over him. Maybe one of the most underrated defenders in this league. Heart rip by Dan Craig on the offside. Vince ahead to Spanger. Speaking of underrated defenders, Steve Perillo is a big fan. He always talks about how good Spanger is.
Oh, yeah.
Down.
Byrne coming out of the corner. Big pick from Kluche. It was wide open, but the ball was tipped, I think. The pass was just knocked away, or he was naked on the crease.
That was almost a perfect pick and roll.
Big swing by Gustafson. That shot goes off of Rose and into the corner. Spanger's going to head off as they get all forwards out now. With the settled offense, and Josh Byrne is the fifth guy out there. Sets a pick for Small, and there's an over and back.
Yeah.
And it will, because Billings is going to get there. to me, those two Corey Small overtime goals, one of the salient points was on both of them, Josh Byrne, huge goal scorer, was setting picks to open him up.
Oh, yeah.
And they were good picks. There's a pass by Reinholdt. Doesn't get through. It's picked off cleanly. Brownell spins around. McKay had run up, but he's picked off. Good transition defense by Toronto.
We've seen a nice transition goal by Buffalo so far, but overall, there hasn't been much offensive transition from them so far this game.
Yeah, the Rock doing a good job getting back and taking that away. Plus, just there's some bounces that come into it. Smith gets clear. Rogers on it, but Smith can't be stopped on that one. Bounces it home. We're all tied up.
Nice play by Smith, and he likes the matchup he sees. Obviously, the pick is there, but then he fakes that shot, just gives him a step on Rogers, and once he's got the step, he's going to get the shot. Now, you think he's going to dive across, and I think that's what fooled Nick Rose, and he just puts it through the five hole on the bounce shot, the high to low bounce shot.
Challen Rogers, very good defender, but anyone, anytime you wind up running out at a player like Dane Smith, you're in trouble.
And he kind of had to because they switched it up on the pick. The nice pick from the Buffalo from his teammate caused the switch, and all of a sudden, Challen Rogers tried to step up on him.
100%, right? Because if you just stay back, you'll rip it from the outside,
exactly.
Gary. That's why he had 72 goals 1 year, because he can do both. Here's Dan Dawson, speaking of a guy who can do many things, hands it off to Hellyer. Sweeting checks him, steps back. Nice slide by John Hernet to take away the chance there. Hellyer still has it, 11 to shoot, Dawson circles. Craig cuts through, he's gonna vacate. Little twister from the top by Hellyer, Vince had no trouble.
Get there. Let's go.
Minichiello. And his forward streaming off the bench. Minichiello will hand it over. You mentioned Graham Perro, and he does his NLL pronunciation guide. We'll get to that in a sec. Off the post by Billings. But I used to pronounce Minichiello Minichiello because I was told that was what it was. I checked because Graham asked me to double check on some names. Marcus said, no, I don't really mind either, but I like the Italian heritage. Let's keep the hard C. What a pass to Chase Fraser, just a bit too far.
Good job.
You can just see those things coming for Buffalo with Billings getting used to them. I bet in a couple of weeks that's right.
Yeah, those passes will be hitting. They seem to be just off, and his teammates have to get used to them too.
Reed Reinholdt. One-on-one with Gilray.
Gilray's playing some good defense. I'm not giving him a step.
And then the switch with Brownell. That's some great D over on that side. Dawson gets underneath McKay. The crease jump and scores. And Dawson, what a lovely touch.
You knew Dawson was taking it to the net once he got half a step like Smith. Now, I would bet that the Buffalo coaches are all going to be watching this replay here to see if there's a chance to challenge.
That's a good goal.
He definitely gets good air. If his toes were fine, I really couldn't see there, but if his toes were fine, you know that ball went in the net before. And I don't think John Tavares had thrown the flag. I was watching the game Buffalo in Vancouver the other day, early in the game. Vancouver scored a goal. Tavares challenged, won the challenge. A few minutes later, Vancouver scored another goal. Tavares won the challenge again. So
he's got
a keen eye for it.
I thought that was fairly clear on the replay.
Yeah.
Dan Dawson celebrating on the Jumbotron as Buffalo goes back in the lead 4-3. And Dan Dawson, who came in needing one assist.
I don't think he's got it yet.
He doesn't. He just keeps shooting tonight. Dane Smith keeps shooting. That one stopped by Rose. Running through the check. And Brock passes it ahead to Dominey, then follows. Dominey thinking about the spin. He gets it. Shoots. Nice save, Vince. Pretty good move. I don't know there was much there.
No, there was nothing there. Although the Rockets scored a couple of goals in similar situations, so I don't blame Dominic for taking that shot.
No, you take the try. Billings takes it from Brownell. Byrne coming out. Fraser. Low shot, hand saved by Rose. What a great little defensive pick there. Is that Rogers? No, Josh Jubenville just allowing his teammate to pick the ball up unharassed because there was a forechecker coming. Brock setting up. Dan Craig has it. Bandits to engage. Jubenville, or sorry, Arnett at the other end picks up the nice job taking away the cut. Craig gets underneath to Snoo, but the Snoo recovers. Then Craig gets loose again. Double under fake.
Oh, it's
picked off. Great job by the Snoo, and all alone is Matt Gilray. He's dangerous on these plays. There's a lovely
nice
finish.
Shot.
deceptive speed by Matt Gilray in these hands.
Oh, really? Gilray didn't have a lot of room where he put this ball. Watching the replay, he puts the one fake in and then he puts it in the top right corner. But this is just a nice loose ball, and Toronto were in big trouble from the moment it was picked up. Yeah, just one fake, and then he uses the momentum to take it to the far side and just place it in. Made it look easy. That was the big loose ball by Mitch Stuthoder to create that play.
What a play to grab and go up over the top. The swim move as he's catching the ball. Gustafson comes away with the faceoff win. Hi to Susie Q and Violet, both tweeting out, saying hello. Everyone who's watching the broadcast, pleased to have you with us. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan. Dan Dawson, oh, what a pass, and Reed Reinholz is on the board.
And we said Dawson needed one assist. Well, he just got it there. His 900th career assist. And what a nice pass. And Reinhold, wrong side of the floor, the recipient of that beautiful Dan Dawson assist that I'm sure Dawson will remember.
I mean, there's a lot of them to remember with 900, but what a great pass, as you said. A very Dan Dawson pass. It wasn't really flashy. It's behind the back, around the head of the defender, but he made it look so simple.
Very much what, you know, we were talking about Garrett Billings, who's one of the great passers in the NLL, has been doing. It just hasn't been connecting yet. Dawson, who's, you know, mid-season form.
Dane Smith through the check and returns fire.
My.
Just sheds Scott Domini like a winter jacket in March. Or even February sometimes.
Yeah, let's watch this. If you're not set up, oh my gosh, you're just standing still in Dawson. Just, I don't know what you really could have done on Smith. He's coming at you full speed, and I don't think you can move fast enough to keep up with him.
He's so quick and so great hands too. I mean, Domini did everything he could from the position he found himself in, but like you said, head of steam for Nate Smith.
And that's what it is, head of steam. It's not like hockey where you can start skating backwards, right? But it's the combination of that speed and size, 6'3", 195 pounds.
5-5, we are all tied up. What was a fairly slow scoring pace early on is picking up, partly due to the transition, but both teams playing fast. I mean, that was Dane Smith going fast, going and attacking.
Oh, yeah.
Billings, pick and roll from Fraser. Great pickup, though, by Sheldon Burns. Lob pass out to Stewart. He's going to see what he's got coming. There's no transition here. Buffalo's got everybody out. Spanger watching him, now retreats. Over to Craig, down in the corner. Hellyer finds Rogers, who's one-on-one with Gilray. The pass and the shot, and a nice save. Vince throws out the arm to deny Craig. And now Gilray's pushing it. It's 3-on-3, 4-on-3, and Dane Smith's the fourth guy. Oh, everyone left Cloutier, and he couldn't catch the pass. Cloutier will dive. That was in. It was. That's a goal. What a play by Cloutier. I couldn't believe that all the Rock defenders just vacated that area.
No, exactly. I can't, you know, he missed that one play, and then I don't know why the Toronto defenders gave him that much room to pick up the ball in the corner and drive the net. I don't think this one hit.
Well, let's see.
Have a look. Matt,
I don't know
Matt
if
Sawyer's watching this.
Has he thrown the flag yet? Has he got the flag? They're not even, they don't even have the flag in their hands, so.
I mean, it did touch mesh, but that's not a perfect angle from above.
No.
He's thinking about it, and I don't think he's going to throw the flag.
No, we're underway at 6-5 Buffalo on the lovely goal by Cloutier.
It's Buffalo's first lead of the game.
Bradley Cree with the ball.
But, you know, getting back to that goal, sloppy defense with Toronto. I mean, they escaped. Oh, my.
That didn't take long.
Sloppy defense by Buffalo.
There you go. And you want to talk about what Rob Hellyer is approaching?
Oh, yeah, so he needs one more goal to get his 200th, I believe. He came into the game with 197. He's got two, correct?
He has. Is that two for him? Yeah.
And again, this time it's Buffalo that just lets Hellyer slip in.
Wow.
And we've been seeing breakdowns on the defense by both teams. I'm sure both sets of coaches won't be happy with how it's gone in the last few minutes.
Well, you know what Yogi Berra said? Good pitching beats good offense, beats good defense, and vice versa. That's a paraphrase.
But nobody goes there anymore. It's too crowded.
Exactly. But, you know, these are good defensive teams. But when you have this kind of offensive talent, sometimes it causes breakdowns. Hellyer surveying.
Right here. No, no, no.
Steps back.
Easy.
Dawson backing
25.
Down. Martin.
He's good. Set.
The shot by Reinhold stopped. Picked up by Noseworthy, who just shovels it ahead to Spanger. 4-on-3 for Buffalo. Spanger feeds it through to Martin, who was a little bit late. He just crossed the top.
Almost a deflection.
Toronto coming the other way. Can he get it through? Domini trying to thread the needle to Hellyer. Didn't quite get there.
Probably forced that one a bit too much.
Yeah. Scott Domini is highly enthusiastic. I think he's a terrific young player. Occasionally, maybe just a touch too enthusiastic. Brownell wanted to get underneath. Damon Edwards was prepared. Here's Smith. Backing down. Spins. No pass. So he's just going to try a shot. Now there's a pass. Healy gets the shot up. Gets up out of play. Didn't touch anybody. And that will be the break. 6:10 to go. And it is 6-6. I'm Stephen Staff with Brian Shanahan. We've got Ashley Docking downstairs. Thanks for being with us. This is BR Live showing you NLL lacrosse.
Welcome back to the broadcast. 6-6 here and a torrid pace against the Bandits and the Rock in the second quarter. I had an opportunity to speak to the Buffalo Bandits defenseman Ian McKay yesterday, and I was asking the biggest difference between JT, John Tavares, of course, being the single coach, as opposed to two coaches last year, JT and Rich Kilgore. They split the Coach of the Year honors, and he said, actually, one thing that's been interesting is that John Tavares has actually spent a lot more time with the defense, than he had before. He said it's super interesting because he kind of shows you the counters that the offense would employ, or at least that he would employ if he was in that position, when the defense get in their various sets. Obviously someone you want to pay attention to when he's coaching you up.
All right, thanks, Ashley. I remember seeing John Tavares play an MSL game when St. Regis came into Peterborough, and they only had about 11 runners. And he honestly, he played the entire game. He played about 50 minutes in the defensive zone. He would just play tough D, strip guys, get the ball, and throw bomb passes.
He's just such a smart player all over the floor. I was lucky enough to play with him for many years, Brampton at Six Nations. Smartest player I ever played with. So sneaky.
I don't know if he would have been a Hall of Famer if he focused on defense. I feel like he might have been. I mean, you don't want to take the all-time leading scorer out of an offensive role, but man, he can do it all. Here's a chance for Rogers. Speaking of guys who do it all, out to Manns. What a laser! Zach Manns with the outside rocket.
Rookie Zach Manns. And we were talking about him, you and I, off air before the game, and I said, he is not afraid to shoot. Like, many rookies often defer to the veterans on the team, and you don't want that. If you think you got a shot where you think you can score, take that shot. And he is not afraid to take the outside shot, and it's a big goal for Toronto, giving the lead again after Buffalo had been trading back and forth.
Yeah, you said at the beginning, 3-0, Buffalo's not worried. Nobody's worried, because they both know there's some goals coming. Gustafson. And Ian McKay out there. Always interesting when the lefties have to switch over to go righty to take the face off.
Zach Manns among the leaders of rookies in the NLL this year in scoring.
Group headed by Connor Fields. Had a couple of games last year. Penalty coming down to Buffalo.
That's going to be our first penalty of the game.
It is.
It's been clean. Buffalo, one of their keys to play 5-on-5. They've done it so far.
Well, now they're playing 5-on-6 as Dan Dawson has to pick that one up off the carpet. They've got time, though. Comes across to Reinhold at the rim. Speaking of guys,
Challen Rogers, right?
Yes, it was.
Challen Rogers scored a goal like that last week, late in the first half, 6-on-5 play against Halifax, and almost the exact same play. And watch what he does. He kind of winds up like he's going to take a sidearm, and then he brings it right over top, goes for the short side. You know, these guys, You know, they're such great shooters. Just the angles that they change their sticks mid-windup is enough to trick the goalies at times.
And young lacrosse players, if you're wondering how you shoot high and hard like Challen Rogers, go back and watch that again. Watch the hip drive. It's not about having strong arms. It's about driving with the legs and rotating your hips hard. Let's go down to Ashley's floor side.
Yeah, thanks, guys. I mentioned it was a torrid pace in this one, and usually when the goalies come to the bench in the quarters, they kind of stick to themselves or talk to the backup. In that last break, Matt Vince came over, and his defense had an earful, so just something to kind of keep an eye on as things get a little bit hectic here in the second.
Man circling, goes far side. Matt Vince has never been shy about letting his defenders know what he likes and doesn't like about what they're doing.
A rookie first second-year goalie can't get away with it. When you're 37 years old and been the goalie of the year seven times, you get that respect. You can give your team the heck you want to give them.
Here comes DeSnew. Nice job by Zach Manns to hustle back and not let Matt Spanger get away, because Spanger was almost gone for an outlet pass. And Manns just kind of grabbed him a little bit, not enough to draw a penalty. But two goals in 25 seconds for the Rock after Buffalo had fought back to tie it up. Here's Byrne spinning. Hostraws are right on him. Evades the pick. Dane Smith.
Wow. This is what you said a little earlier. You know, he can take that shot from the outside or he can run you over. Nice tricky shot. Let's watch this shot by Dane Smith. Bit of a screen here. Short, that's a perfect short side shot.
The officials just reining everything in at that goal. There's some pushing and shoving. Chase Fraser and a couple of Rock players getting into it. Today's officials, the crew chief is Ryan Fowler. He's assisted by Sean Grenier and Kyle Kropman. The shot clock operator is Davey Hallett. I spent most of yesterday with Dave Hallett. That's what I called two Arena Lacrosse League games.
Oh, gosh.
In Oshawa, Dave was reffing both of those, so he's a busy guy.
So are you.
I am. I had the game Friday night, too. Dave wasn't at that one. So. John Harnett takes the pass.
15 goals. We're still in the first half.
Yeah. I'm not sure that's what I expected. He's very talented, but, man. 100 points for Corey Small with Buffalo now.
That's a Buffalo bad. Not bad, yeah.
It's his second year with the team. There's Dane Smith. Nice pass. Byrne. Oh, he stumbles. Josh Byrne is human. Well, maybe not.
Oh,
look at that play.
That?
Oh, big hit. There's a penalty coming. He grabbed his head immediately. Sheldon Byrnes ran into him. We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll see how Josh Byrne is. He definitely looks a little shaken up. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan. Thanks for being with us. This is the NLL on VR Live. Next weekend, the Vancouver Warriors come here to Scotiabank Arena to take on the Rock in an alternate cup matchup. Catch the action on BR Live starting at 7 p.m. Eastern Time. And right now, let's hear what Matt Sawyer's had to say.
Just relax. We're going to get in a groove. I realize we haven't played much 5-on-5, okay? Just the way the game's going. Stick with it. Also talk about, though, you never know with the big moments in games. I know it's real early, boys. Just sense here. If we can stick together three or four good 5-on-5 sets, you're going to get some separation. Let's go. It's a key moment.
Matt Sawyer mic'd up, and Shanny, that last play. The penalty.
Yeah. We're going to have a look at this penalty call again. And watch to see a beautiful play. Rose has no idea where it is. I'm not, you know, maybe it did make contact with the head. I actually thought he missed, but.
Sometimes even a glancing blow can be a factor. So Challen Rogers and David Brock will be high on the penalty kill. And it's Hostrazer. And
they're parking a guy behind the net, too.
Yeah, they've got Byrne behind the net.
And you see how dangerous he is from there.
Smith to Kluche behind the back. Small goes back to Kluche as they go strong left. Smith with Cree. Ray out on him. That leaves Fraser alone. Great save, Nick Rose, as Fraser was naked on the crease. Cree fights through the double team. Oh, nice job holding on to it and getting into the offensive zone. Brad Cree, so strong. He is really, in the last year and a half.
He's their best defender in my books this year.
One of the best in the league.
I like the way Buffalo puts a guy behind the net, because if nothing else, it forces Nick Rose back into his net.
Saved by Vince on the shot late in the shot clock by Dawson. Good kill by Toronto. Not a lot of pressure from Buffalo. They're content to get it back and have it go this time. There's still a minute to go in the penalty. McKay steps across the floor. You mentioned earlier, McKay, a second-year player. I was like, really? He was a rookie just last year. He's such a bomb veteran.
Oh, Gilray as well. They both scored goals. Exactly. Nice transition goals by both of them.
Of course, the third and fourth. Oh, backdoor attempt tipped away.
And let's not forget Kluche in there, too.
Second, third, and fourth picks in last year's draft.
They've all scored this game.
Yeah, Kluche, Gilray, and McKay in order. Here's Brock, the outlet pass from Rose. And Toronto can kill most of the rest of this penalty. If they can take the full 30, Buffalo's probably not going to have a chance to do much when they get the ball back.
And I don't think Buffalo's going to be chasing.
And who knows, maybe they'd be a little more aggressive if they hadn't played Friday and then traveled yesterday. You got to be smart about these things. Craig spins off. Three on the shot clock. You're going to shoot or just roll it? He'll just roll it.
Piece of equipment on the floor. I think it's somebody's glove.
That was John Arnett. Lost a mitten. Goes and recovers it.
8 seconds. I don't think they're going to take a shot unless they time it for when the Burns comes out of the box and gets back in their end. You don't want to give Burns a breakaway.
No. All even as Burns comes back. Josh Byrne on his offside. And Nick Rose didn't budge. I don't think he saw that ball at all.
Yeah, we've seen some excellent shooting by both teams, and you know they're making two very good goaltenders look weak at times. There's nothing wrong with this play by Nick Rose. Again, much like that last Smith shot, it's well placed. It's almost a perfect shot. You know, when you're an angle goalie, and I think Nick Rose is an angle goalie, most of the times he makes it look easy stopping those outside shots. But once in a while, you get shooters like Smith and Byrne. We just find the opening.
Yeah, it doesn't matter what side they're on. Let's go quickly down to Ashley at the floor.
Yeah, thanks, guys. Talking to Corey Small yesterday, one of the things he said is that their offense is super balanced, so it's a really nice offense to be a part of because they're unpredictable. He did add, unprompted, I will say, between Josh Byrne and Chase Fraser, these two are two of the best athletes he's ever seen play lacrosse. We've got some pretty special talent on this team.
It's a pretty special drive by Chase Fraser. Yeah, he just couldn't quite finish. Throws the punch at Taylor Stewart.
Yeah, I think you're probably going to see both of those guys going there.
Yeah, I mean, Taylor's laying on
Stewart's
leg.
Stewart stayed on him a little longer, and Fraser definitely gave the punch.
You mentioned you saw Fraser go down and limping off a little earlier, and he is definitely looking uncomfortable now.
Oh, it almost looks like a bit of a tackle by Stewart. He's got his arms around his legs.
But I still think born of frustration.
Looks to me like it's both guys going still.
I don't think Fraser's going to go serve it. I think they'll send the in-home Minichiello because he's going to get some treatment. Yeah, Minichiello's coming off the bench. He'll go serve.
Blue ball.
So Josh Byrne takes over the league lead in goals. He came in with 21. In this game, into this game.
He's gonna stay. There's a big differential between the number of games all the teams have played. You know, I think Vancouver's already played 10, and some teams are on their sixth, so it's tough looking up there at the top scorers and really getting a good feel. But we know Burns is up there with the goals, and Smith is up there for the points.
Yeah, he is. Josh Byrne started the game, as I said, with 21, tied with Shane Jackson, who's had 3 goals in each of Georgia's 7 games.
Very consistent.
Man, Josh Byrne is dangerous. That one trickles through Vince, but it goes wide. It's scooped up by Hellyer. Takes a peek to make sure he's got the fresh 30. See who he's got. Over to Dawson. All kinds of movement by the Rock offense. Sweeting D's up on Dawson. It comes to Craig. Fights through Spanger. Shot off. Saved by Vince. That's through the crease. Buffalo gets it. Just knew ahead to Gilray. Going to probe and see if there's anything there. There's not, so he'll pass it back to Smith and stay out. Whoa, that was blocked by Brad Cree, who did not feel very good. He's hobbling a little bit.
Might be picking up an assist off his butt.
Edwards' shot goes wide. Didn't touch anybody, so Buffalo's going to get the ball. We're nearing the end of the first half, 36 seconds to go. They called a timeout, Buffalo. Yeah,
called a timeout.
Or is it? Can't be Toronto, can it? Good matchup. I thought the refs pointed towards the Buffalo bench. Because it was a dead ball, either team could still call it.
Yeah.
So we'll see if Buffalo pulls Vince again. 35.1 seconds. That would be pretty dangerous.
Apparently it is a Buffalo timeout.
Do you pull Vince if you're Buffalo?
Nope.
No. If you do, it's just to have the six guys. You've got lots of time.
Well if you do, you pull and then put them back. Yeah. Yeah. They may do that.
Vince is at the bench, of course, for the timeout. But there are only five runners gone out, so it doesn't look like it. No, he's heading back.
Well, and it's rare, but once in a while we see the late goal when a team pulls the goalie. Last week, Brody Merrill scored one from the corner in his own end.
He was almost standing in the ocean on that one. Yeah, yeah. Oh, that was in Vegas. It wasn't anywhere near the ocean.
Right.
I take it all back.
He was standing in the casino.
There you go. And he struck gold. Kluche runs up as Matt Vince jogs back to the net. Here's Smith to Billings. I keep thinking Billings is going to just start to click at some point. Burn. Little pick from Small to Billings to Smith. Stutter step by Burns. Hostrauser meets him, knocks the ball loose. Rolling around, Kluche will get it. Brock is on him. It pops loose. He's still got it. Four to shoot. It's loose. And Toronto's got it. They will take their timeout with 5 seconds to go. And boy, Buffalo, as that ball popped loose, you can see they just wanted to knock it away so they could get a chance. But the Rock will have a chance to set up. And they will pull Nick Rose.
Yeah, they will pull Nick Rose in. The last 6-on-5, we saw Rogers up top for the big shot. That's tough to defend because, you know, the one thing on 6-on-5 you have to give is the long outside shots. And I think if they decided to shut out Rogers, you got Hellyer out there, another weapon, so I can't see Buffalo doing that. Last week, Rogers, at the end of the first half, scored a goal with less than a second to go on the 6-on-5 with Nick Rose pulled.
I wonder if it was a factor for Buffalo at all that Chase Fraser, with Minichiello still in the box, Chase Fraser can't play, right? He can't come in and play until his time has been served.
That's right, yeah.
Since he came in with an injury, I'm 99% sure. Hellyer will start with it. Everybody's available for Toronto. 6 seconds put on the clock. Kyle Kropman waves it in. Hellyer sprints over to Rogers, and he loses the ball. That will be the end of the first half. Just knew how to go, and a collision.
A lot of bodies down.
Challen Rogers upset with himself, but yeah, guys were falling left, right, and center.
I see Ian McKay is down. He's looking hurt.
11 goals in that quarter to give us 16 for the half.
Oh, and they were coming rapidly.
Wow. I mean, at one point we heard that Toronto had 2 and 25 seconds. We pointed that out. I mean, they just kept coming. And a lot of bodies. It seems
you don't want to start dropping. You know, sometimes that's what happens. You play a couple games in a row, it's the injuries that pile up.
Let's go to Ashley with Dan Dawson.
Thanks so much, guys. Joined by Dan Dawson right now. Dan, the pace of this game is torrid. I know you guys pride yourselves on your conditioning and your athleticism. So do you think it plays into your hands?
Yeah, I thought we got to push the pace. They're coming back from a long flight out west and a big game on Friday night. So, but they're matching our energy. I just think that both teams are a little bit not really executing well. And that's the biggest key. It's a rapid pace, but I mean, there's a lot of drop balls out here. And we got to clean that stuff up. The great thing about it, it's correctable.
So would you like to see a little bit more patience on the offensive end? Not saying that you need to be more reserved and not take your opportunities, but maybe just be a bit more pragmatic.
You're exactly right. I think transition is where you play fast. And then offense, there's times where you go fast, but at times I think when you got a tired defense, you break them down the last 10 seconds of a shot clock, not the first 10 seconds. So I think we need to do a better job of that.
Thank you so much, Dan.
No problem.
Good luck in the second. All right. It's an 8-8 game here. It's a tight one. It's physical. Why would you think anything else was going to happen? Two divisional rivals, one of whom eliminated the team in the Eastern Conference Finals last year.
Welcome back inside Scotiabank Arena. I am Stephen Stamp, and what an exciting half that was, Brian Shanahan. A lot of really nice goals, and we need to look at a bunch of them.
Oh, yeah, and there's a lot to choose from. 16 goals so far in the half, and it started in that first quarter. Toronto Rock got the early lead. They went up 2-0 on a nice transition goal. We're going to see it in a second here. Starts with Mitch Gustafson started the play. That's his first career NLL point, but Jubinville finishes off. They gave Toronto a 2-0 lead. They went up 3-0, but as we said, that doesn't mean a lot in these games, but this one actually made it 3-2 as Josh Byrne, who is so good on the crease, scores his first goal of the game. Then Dane Smith, probably the NLL's leading scorer right now. I haven't looked to see what Vancouver's doing. That tied it up 3-3. Toronto goes up 4-3 on a goal by Dan Dawson. Also had a monumental assist later on. And then you're going to see Smith again. Just run over his man, put it in. That's his second goal of the game. That tied it up at 5. Buffalo went ahead. Toronto ties it up again, 6-6. Hellyer getting his second goal of the game. Zach Manns, the rookie, is going to take an outside shot here. That gave Toronto a 7-6 lead. They scored a couple of quick goals at that point, but then Buffalo comes back again. And again, that was Dane Smith. Yes, Dane Smith scoring his hat trick goal, and then Josh Byrne scoring another goal. Nice shot. That tied it up 8-8, and that's what we are now.
And we're going to take a look at the stats through the half. You can see the goal is obviously tied up. The shots on goal almost tied up. Buffalo's missed the net more. Faceoffs in Toronto's advantage, but not many penalties to speak of.
Yeah, it's been a pretty clean game so far. That's what Buffalo said. They want to play 5-on-5, but it's been a lot of excitement.
Not usually what they do, spending a lot of time 5-on-5. We're going to take a break, and we will be back to more Buffalo and Toronto action. It's 8-8 through the half. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan and Ashley Docking. We'll be back with the NLL on BR Live.
Thank you for joining us for NLL at the Half. Ashley Docking joined today by Scott Dominey. Now, Scott, a really big year for you so far. You know, last year you played one game, had a really memorable goal in that one, actually. But this year, you're someone that this defensive core depends on. The hard work doesn't go unnoticed to kind of crack the lineup. What kind of went into things during the offseason?
Sawyer just said get in the MSL and try to play with some men, and that's what I did in the summer. I went out to Kohlberg and had a long drive there, but put in the work and just started playing with some men and got my feet under me.
So it must have given you a lot of confidence, as I'm sure the Rock signing you to a 2-year deal, right?
Yeah, definitely. It was nice to see that Jamie believes me and the team believes me and gave me a 2-year deal, and I'm not going to let that go unnoticed.
So one of the things that I was talking to Nick Rose about earlier this week was the fact that it's just such a good group in there that everyone's really, really supportive. So I'm assuming that there's someone that maybe you turn to when you need advice, I guess, in a mentor capacity. Who would that be?
All the boys are pretty nice. You can go to every one of them. Jonesy, Billy, they're all good veteran players that you can go and sit down and talk to and have a little joke with. But all the boys are good.
Billy seems like a bit of a tough nut to crack, though, when I was talking to him. He's just completely open and honest with you. I guess he would be someone that kind of just tells it how it is.
Definitely tells you how it is, and he's a good one to joke with. He's pretty quick-witted.
Okay, so that group in general, some of the guys that you mentioned, including yourself, a really athletic group. Definitely. How much do you guys lean on that in terms of your game plan night in and night out?
I think it's big. I think Damon Edwards just shows us how hard work pays off, and then we get Jubinville and me and all the boys putting in the work. It's going to pay off in the long run, and the game has really turned to a transition kind of game, so running that ball and being strong is going to win some games.
And do you feel that plays into some of your strengths, the transition focus for you guys?
Definitely. I think transition was the big part I made the NLL, and I'm going to keep that going all the way through.
Okay, so for Buffalo today, obviously a hyper-talented offense. They're very well-balanced. Yep. What is some of the things that you can do to limit their effectiveness? Because you obviously can't shut everyone down, but no, Sheldon Burns was saying that you got to make them uncomfortable. So what does that entail?
Being uncomfortable is getting, like, when they're going to set an up pick, push them out. Don't let them walk around in your space. When they're serving with the ball, you want to be on their hands, just getting on them. Don't give them time and space, and just be physical. Don't let them. They had a game on Friday in Vancouver, and they're going to be a little bit sore. So get in their face, give them a rough one, and there you go.
All right, well, thank you so much for your time.
No problem. Thank you.
No problem. That's Scott Dominey. I'm Ashley Docking. This has been NLL at the Half. We'll be back with second half action in just a moment.
Live is brought to you by Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit geico.com to see how much you could save. And by Alterna Savings, Alterna offers easy, more personal financial services and puts the good in banking. Visit alterna.ca to learn more. BR Live makes watching live sports easy. Download or visit to watch all of the National Lacrosse League action and more with BR Live. Listen to the Toronto Rock Total Access Podcast with hosts Mike Hancock and Rock alumni and Hall of Famer Colin Doyle. Subscribe today for the inside scoop on your favorite NLL team. New episode available every week on SoundCloud and iTunes. Subscribe today so you don't miss out. Stay up to date on all the news, announcements, and exclusive prizes with the NLL newsletter. Sign up now at NLL.com.
Hey, lacrosse friends, welcome back to Scotiabank Arena. It is 8-8. We are going to take a peek at the standings in the Northern Division, or the North Division, and it's pretty tight. The Halifax and Buffalo come into this game both at 6-1. Toronto at 4-2.
This is such a hugely important game for the Rock to sort of crawl back into that fight with the other two teams.
As we mentioned earlier, you know, the two teams at the top of the division get directly into the playoffs, so it's really important for these teams to come in those top two.
We've got a barn burner here at 8-8, and apparently in Rochester, the game is going into overtime between the Vancouver Warriors and the Rochester Nighthawks.
Mitch Jones didn't like giving up the goal-scoring lead to Josh Byrne, so he's tied him back up.
Well, they must have tied late, because when I last looked, it was a one-goal lead in the last minute, so he must have tied it up very late that game.
5 seconds to go, he tied it up.
Oh, my gosh.
So there's some action there, and there's lots of action here. Kevin Brownell starting with the ball. Tries to throw back to Small. He won't get there in time. It's an over and back. And Toronto will take possession. Not what you're aiming for the first possession of the half, but there's lots of time to go here, of course. Rob Hellyer creeping up on 200 career goals. Big pick by Dan Dawson on Desnoux. The save by Vince. What a pick and roll by Dawson. Then another save by Vince. Palace gets his rebound, but Sweeting separates him from the ball. Here comes John Harnett, the veteran.
Now, the two players from both teams who went in the penalty box are still there, and I'm not sure if Frazier is serving his own penalty now, and I'm not even sure if you're allowed to change once you put an in-home in.
That's a great question.
Oh, off the crossbar. I was just checking, it was 19 seconds remaining on the penalties.
That's a bad break. He caught the ball and just stepped over the line. If he had not bothered catching the ball, that wouldn't have been over and back.
Right, just let it go.
Yeah, let it go.
Chase it down, but it's coming right at you. It's hard to not react.
Yeah, your instinct is just catch it. His momentum took him just over that line.
Hellyer, across the top. Tucking underneath is Reinhold. Gilray checks him. Reinhold trying to go in there again. Again, Gilray stops him. This is Rogers. Rips it. Took that jab step like he was going to cut underneath and then just fired the shot, but it gets wide.
Yeah, that missed by a lot.
Yeah. McKay hands it off. So good to see McKay
I just noticed it is Frazier in the penalty box.
Okay, so they will get out at the next hard stop as their time has been served.
And that's good news for Buffalo because he must be all right to play.
Yes. The outlet pass, Sheldon Burns. Saw it in the last moment, he caught it. Garner taking their time to set up on O. Dawson gets a pick from Hellyer. Pick from Gustafson out for an offensive shift. Another pick. Spinning. Three to shoot. Gets a shot off, and Vince had no trouble with it. Mitch Desnoux making very clear that he had some time if he's going to catch that ball just over center, like you talked about. You don't want to catch it right around the line if you can avoid it. There's Billings. Steps around a pick. Nice defense by Brock and Domini. Domini now jumps out onto Brownell. Cloutier goes through everybody and misses the net.
My, that was such a nice play by Cloutier, except for the shot. Again, Buffalo's called it the over back, and it's similar again.
Stu doesn't like it. He didn't think he had... I think he thought it was touched by a Toronto player, and then he didn't have control.
I think what the referee called is that the referee's opinion was he had control and brought it back over the line.
Yeah. I think he felt like he was just establishing control. That's a fine line. Harnett gets through the man, has the ball. Oh, great trail check. What a strip. Robbie Hellyer coming back.
You don't see Robbie Hellyer playing a lot of defense, but on the run back, he always gives a great effort.
He only played it for about a half a second there. He just came back and stripped him. Dan Dawson over to Hellyer, who's now going to play some offense. Jubinville's there sending picks.
Well, looks like Toronto's being aggressive on their picks, been called with illegal picks a few times. You want to push the envelope, though.
I was just going to say, you always want to find where the line is. Usually you do it in the first quarter, not in the beginning of the third quarter. We had a torrid scoring pace for a while. None so far in the third, and still none as Nick Rose stops Byrne. Byrne's getting into it with Hostrauser. I think he's tangled up. Oh, yeah, Hostrauser had a stick. There's a shot at the other end. Adam Jay stopped by Vince. Johnny Palace got trail checked by Minichiello coming back. Minichiello's having himself a good game for a youngster.
Playing well. Nice opportunity by Jay. He looked like challenged Rogers the way he hesitated on that shot to get as close as he could.
Boy, that goal Jay scored a couple weeks ago coming out of the corner, just magic.
All effort, yeah.
Luce off the post. Got a bit of Rose, then onto the iron. Comes straight out to Byrne, fresh 30.
Toronto's had a hard time stopping Cluche. He could probably have about four goals right now if he was getting all the shots on net.
I believe he had four last week, or was it Friday? I know I remember looking and seeing he had a 4-4.
He's having a much better second season than he did as a rookie. Had 15 goals coming into this game last year, scored 19 goals all season.
He's looking so active this year. Here's a chance for Toronto. Dan Craig gets drilled after the shot. 25 on 25 violence as Spanger nails him. Here comes Rogers. He's grabbed by Harnett. Ball pops loose. And there is the overtime final. Vancouver on a goal by who? Mitch Jones.
Mitch Jones.
He is now leading the league in goals for the moment. We'll see what Josh Byrne does in the final.
Could be leading the league in points. We'll have to check that out too.
Yep. He had a bunch of assists. So I think he has. He had, I think, five assists last time I looked. Go with a couple of goals at that point. Here's David Brock on the run. He had a great transition season last year. He's going to pull up and rip it. That is a beauty. The little hesitation and the delayed celly. He hesitates on the shot, hesitates on the celly.
And not your typical David Brock goal. Not that he typically scores, but, usually you see the transition goal. You're running in on a breakaway or 2-on-1. This one, he just backs in and just rips a shot to the short side. How many goals have we seen from both teams to that short side? Yeah. If you could squeeze that in, there's only a few inches left on the short side. And if you can squeeze it in, it's very difficult for the goalie to stop. He's always worried about, the top right corner, not that short side.
And the typical transition goal that we see so much is, right, you're streaming down, you get the shot on the run.
You're right.
Sometimes you just pull up in that little hesitation. We saw Nick Weiss score a huge goal for Buffalo last week where he peeled out, went and scored a big goal. It can really change the dynamic of what the opponents are expecting. Here comes Jubinville, across center, hands it off to Hellyer. Dawson. Hellyer goes back to the far side. We've got three lefties out there for Toronto. Hellyer. Martin on him, switched it off, and DeSnoot just got there as Hellyer was shooting. This is McKay with it.
Nick Rose got the assist on that goal. Both goalies have got nice assists.
Byrne watched by Cree. Decides to step back and get the ball to Small and then get back in the return pass. Pick from Cloutier, saved by Rose. Hostrauser had it for a moment. It gets away, but Rose gets it.
Oh,
long
boy,
pass, that's too high.
Yep.
Oh, it got cool. Away from him.
Yep.
Boy, almost had a repeat of Scott Domini's brilliant goal last year, his first in the league, the Nick Rose perfect outlet pass and Domini.
And generally, Rose has a very accurate pass, too.
Very accurate. You can see it take off on him.
Slipped out of his stick.
Here's Billings. Luce trying to duck underneath. Creek spins back. Byrne alone. Penalty coming as Fraser is on the ground again. And Damon Edwards is still arguing. He's trying to still play defense as the extra attacker comes out. Luce sees that one's there. Looks around and just lets it fly. It's going to be a roughing call. But we will be back for a break. 8:16 to go. Just one goal so far into the third quarter. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan and Ashley Docking. It's the NLL on BR Live.
Welcome back to Scotiabank Arena. Now, I had the opportunity to catch up with Toronto Rock goaltender Nick Rose before this one, and he gave me two pieces of information that I think are really pertinent to the reason that Toronto has had success so far this year. First, he says this is the most prepared his team has been, and he's been here a long time, so that says a lot. Gave kudos to the coaches and also gave kudos to the players for taking it upon themselves to execute the tasks that have been required of them. He also said that there's a level of accountability in the locker room. That's really great because no one has to really call each other out. People know when they had an off game. People know when they make a mistake. They put their hand up and say, yeah, that was me. And everyone moves on together. Guys.
Thanks, Ashley. And we're going to take a quick peek at what resulted in the power play we're about to watch. Look at the left of your screen.
Yeah, that's Damon Edwards. I don't know. I didn't think it looked that bad.
I didn't think it looked that bad either, actually.
But, you know, Fraser has been taking a bit of a beating. I like the rule, and I'm not saying this was, I like that they're calling it embellishment more in this league. And
I do too. I was just going to say, I like it.
We saw one last week, and it actually got called against Toronto on Damon Edwards. He went down. The referee thought he didn't need to go down.
Small rips it saved by Rose. I like that they're calling it, and you know that they're watching for it.
And they can even call it, even if it's a legitimate penalty.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
That's fair.
Postrosser turns back. And, I mean, Kyle Kropman was right there, and they are watching for it this year, so that makes me think that he saw something, that there was some legitimate contact.
Yeah,
you know, it is a call that's being made.
In general, I think the refs do a really good job in the league.
Yeah.
Can't believe I'm saying that.
We can quibble with anything, any call you can quibble with, but for the most part, they get most of them right. That's unofficial. Yeah. They do very well. Buffalo back to the man advantage. Kluche at the top. Small circling around behind him. They set it up. 17 to shoot. Kluche. Pick from Byrne. Kluche. Saved by Rose. Got away from him for a second, but not too far.
Buffalo 0 for 1 on the only power play of this game. Toronto would have had a power play, but they scored on the 6 on 5, you know, on the delay.
Right. Hellyer takes it from Dawson.
Buffalo should get one more chance here and another 30.
Yeah, there'll be about a full 30 left at the end of Toronto's possession here. Unless they can get a reset, which will be the goal in a couple of seconds. Zach Mantz is going to get a shot off if he can. No, he's just going to leave it in the corner.
Good job by Buffalo. You know, mostly Ian McKay, who just made sure he couldn't step back and shoot. He stayed right on his hands. Because you're right.
Go ahead.
You like to get that late shot and try for a rebound or see it go out of bounds.
Well, that game winner for Mitch Jones, put it back ahead. Byrne doesn't take the chance to try and tie him there. He's not thinking about that.
No.
He doesn't even know about it, of course, so he can't. But he will rip it, though. It's a little bit wide. Billings going after it now. He's not even close. That one went straight back over center.
And that overtime loss has got to be heartbreaking for Rochester, who lost in overtime to the Buffalo Bandits last week. So right. That's 2 weeks in a row, overtime losses.
And late goals.
Late goals against, to put it in overtime.
Yeah. Very final moments of the game, giving up tying goals. Shows that Rochester's close, but you know that team wants to not be close. They want to win. Here's Hellyer. Ellis feeds it through, can't quite connect with Reinholt. Nobody's there for Toronto. Gilray takes it for Buffalo.
Look at that.
He's
look
got
at that
Fraser
speed.
Ahead. It's just too high for him. Cree couldn't get it, so Fraser's able to track it down. We are back to even strength.
Fraser came flying off that bench.
Looks like he's okay. We did see him go down earlier, couldn't serve his penalty because he was a little dinged up after Stewart landed on him. Toronto gets it back. Burns on the run. It's the trailer, Rogers. Rogers taking his time. Hellyer quickly over to Craig. Couple of picks.
Well, that's a hard shot.
You can hear the ricochet. Hellyer?
Yeah.
Yeah, off of Mintz. Here comes J.P. Keeley. Back playing a defensive shift there for Buffalo. Shot by Byrne. Turned aside. Keeley, I believe he won a AL Cup championship with the Whippy Steelhawks a couple years ago. They're in their expansion season.
Yeah, it's good to see a number of players from the ALL making it, getting their chances in the NLL.
Here's Hellyer's shot wide. I think we're going to see a lot more as we have expansion. You know, a lot of rumors about what's going to be happening. There are more teams coming, though.
Look at that.
Oh, what a pass. What a catch by Dawson. And the spinning shot
with
Vince. Legend stopping legend. Vince with the save on Dawson. We have reached the break with 4:25 to go in the third quarter. Only one goal in the first 10 and a half minutes of this third quarter. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan and Ashley Docking. Coming right back for the NLL on BR Live. Here are the next couple of upcoming games for the Rock here at Scotiabank Arena. They're back in 6 days to host the Vancouver Warriors February 15th, then away from it and return Sunday, March 8th for Kids Day and a matchup against another West Division team, the defending champion Calgary Optics. Get your tickets at torontorock.com. And now let's hear some more from Matt Sawyer, mic'd up.
You can't be scared of it, all right? Reed could not have reacted and got to the bench any quicker. It still wasn't enough. Go home. Go to the center zone, all right? We do that there. They turn and they pull it out, all right? So what I'm saying is he reacted instantly on the shot. He got to the bench. It's still not enough. You've got to go to the center zone, read, and react from there, all right?
So he's talking about the fast break that I assume it was the one by Frazier. So it's not enough to run straight to the bench after the shot. They got to go to a safer area earlier.
Here we go. Vince going to the bench.
I don't think there's a delayed call, is it?
No, they're going sneaky 6-on-5 with Frazier. The save by Rose. Vince is heading back, and Billings gets it, so Toronto won't have any chance in the empty net. Play is blown down, and Nick Rose is adjusting his helmet.
Oh.
You always stop the clock, the game, right away if the goalie needs to fix his helmet. Anybody else, the helmet comes off, they can run to the bench, they can put it back on, whatever, but the goalie, now you got to stop. Smith and Small playing catch down to Cloutier. Billings jousting out front with Jubinville. Frazier trying to fight through the check from Edwards, gets a slip pick. Great job by Cree, taking away the drive to the net. Frazier again is slow to get up. He's taking a pounding today.
Yeah,
he is limping.
He's definitely limping.
And in a couple of minutes, he's such an athlete, we're going to see him flying off the pitch. You
well,
just know it.
You got to think it's partly the accumulative effect because they played on Friday night.
Yes, for sure.
You know, like most of these guys are hurting after every game.
Yeah.
And when you play two games in 3 days, it just adds up a bit. But I agree with you. I bet he's not going to be going to the dressing room or sitting on the bench.
If you ever get a chance to be down in the locker room area after a game, the number of guys with ice all over them, they take a pounding. That pass doesn't connect as everyone was tangled up. Craig with 5 seconds on the shot clock. Gilray on him, pick from Manz. That's a nice pick, but the block by Brent Noseworthy. Noseworthy's a real up-and-comer. Boy, he'd only played, he was a goalie through most of his junior career and then started playing out as a runner. When he was drafted, he'd only played about 50 games as a runner in box lacrosse. Remarkably
that
fast
was like,
improvement.
Eric Fennell did the same thing.
Here's Byrne.
Oh,
misses the net. Again, lands around the goal line. What an athlete. Couldn't quite finish, though. Brock want to add to their one-goal lead. Shots 40-35 for the Bandits at this moment. Hellyer taking his time. Up to Dawson. Little fake. Hardhead warily watching him. A little pick by Hellyer actually got him a slightly out of position to take the pass. Gets it over to Paulus, or sorry, to Reinholt. A couple of Rock players going to the bench as it's late in the 30 and the ball's dropped. Here comes Desnoux. And there's the wave of blue across the restraining line. to meet the Bandits' transition attempt. Final 2 minutes of the third quarter. Small to Blue Chain, comes to set a pick, slips it, shoots around the pick to Snoo, is just locked on with Sheldon Burns, but the save by Rose. Edwards is directing traffic.
I think Blue Chain might have had more good shots or good opportunities than anybody in this game.
Yeah, I think that's true. Hellyer. Reinhold surveying his options, gives it off to Hellyer. Back to the far side. Mans will give it up.
Good defense by Buffalo.
Oh, and as you say that.
Until I jinx them.
Yes, yeah. Craig wide open. I was going to say Toronto being pushed late into the shot clocks on every possession. And, you know, you want to be patient, take the shot that's when it's available. But a lot of that is Buffalo just not giving them much until, as you said, you jinxed them until the last second. Not too much, though. No goal. Burn over to Billings. Pick from Smith. Rip. Stopped by Rose. Goes straight back to Billings. Taylor Stewart on him. He's doing pretty good.
Good job by Stewart.
Yeah, his first game with the Rock.
Got called for the push, I believe.
Yep. He and Fraser have a little tap for each other. I'd like to see that respect. And then he starts whacking him with his stick. Josh Byrne, watched by Cree, has to spin to stick with him. Smith comes into some space, but nice job by Dominey. Penalty coming off the post, back out to Keeley around the world, just missed on the far side. Billings trying to get it, it's going to be Fraser picking it up, but Buffalo retains possession. He's rammed into the boards, and that will end the play, and Fraser is banged up.
He is taking a beating, but as you said, we'll keep coming back. Let's watch, see if we can see what happened in the penalty in the middle of your screen. I don't know if that was it, or that's it.
I think that's it.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, I mean, it could have been, but then.
Now, and sometimes when a pick comes, you try to fight through the pick, but I guess that fight through went a little bit high in the referee's view.
And that's instantaneous. That's not, there are some penalties that are just dumb penalties. That's definitely not one.
No, and I think Keeley made sure the head bobbed back so the referee could see it.
Burns' hard shot is stopped. Here's the outlet pass. Rogers running onto it. I think that bounced off of Kyle Crawford.
It did.
Rogers still gets it. Byrne, I talked to Byrne on the podcast on Boxing Beat about going back to play D. He said they all get familiar with it and that they could, all the off-forwards get coached a lot on it. Here they come on O.
Oh, and the corner's gonna run out.
Yeah, Corey Small running into space, had a lane to the net, but the clock expires. We're through 45 minutes of play. Just one goal in that third quarter. It is now 9-8 for the Toronto Rock. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan and Ashley Docking. Thanks for being with us here in the Scotiabank Arena. It's BR Live, NLL.
Welcome back to the broadcast. I'm joined by Buffalo Bandits assistant coach Rusty Kruger, and this game is a physical, and I know that Toronto really wanted to get aggressive with you guys, knowing that it's your second game this weekend. Do you feel like you're matching that physicality?
Oh, we knew they were going to bring it. No, it's a divisional matchup here, so we're just going to see if we can we'll find a way to pull this one out.
One of the things about a fast-paced game is that execution isn't always there offensively. Do you guys think you've tightened it up as this game's went on?
Oh, for sure. We're trying to tighten up back there. Vino's holding us in there. And like I said, it's going to be a grind, and hopefully we can pull it out.
Thanks, Rusty.
Thank you.
All right, guys, back to you.
Thanks, Ashley and Rusty Kruger. 15 minutes to go or so.
Many great players to come out of Orangeville.
Yeah. Great chat she had with Scott Dominey, speaking about Orangeville guys earlier. And Scott Dominey, he is just indomitable. I loved what he did a couple years ago. Before his first season with the Rock, he was a superstar in Coupley. Still is. One of the all-time greats. Up there like Sean Williams territory.
Who did he play for?
He plays for Nipissing University.
Oh, okay.
The Lakers. He's a multi-time All-Canadian. And in the playoff game against Queens, he took a vicious check at the end of the game when it was out of reach, and he had to miss the Gatoway Cup, their first ever Gatoway Cup championship weekend. And it was a separated or dislocated shoulder, and he was so disheartened, but he was like, I'm just going to keep working at it. And he got into the Rock lineup later in the season. It looked like he was going to be gone for the year, but he came back and he scored that great goal last year.
Scored two goals last week against Halifax.
Billings back to Kluche. see if Buffalo's power play can find its groove. Billings over to Kluge. Close shot, the save by Rose. Big collisions. Oh, what a play.
Nice play. Who was that?
Hostrauser just shovels it ahead.
Really nice play. And, you know, Andy and I have said many times, most improved rock player over the last 5 years. He's really become a valuable, smart player.
He really came in as a tough guy,
exactly,
playing that role, and just worked and worked and worked to make himself a better defender.
He's still got that in his arsenal, but he doesn't have to fight much.
Spanger and Sweeting double team on Dawson, but he fights through and gets it behind the back. Just missed. It's grabbed by Harnett. Well, that's a nice little fake. And he'll throw it ahead to Spanger.
Reminiscent of Dawson last week when he threw a penalty late in the game for Toronto.
Still time on the penalty, 18 in the power play for Buffalo. Orthon's on the shot clock, so they will be looking for a shot here. Kluge behind the net, the dunk attempt. Well, played perfectly by Rose.
Knew that was coming, and a good thing Nick Rose knew that was coming.
Oh my. Here's a break the other way. Domini,
what a catch.
And then doesn't take the shot. He realizes he was bumped past by Kevin Brownell past the scoring area. Maintains his poise.
That was one of the best catches that I've seen. That was like
unbelievable.
Reaching back, one hand on the stick.
Backing down is Rob Hellyer. Craig, and that's one of the things. I mean, Domini, he's an attack in infield lacrosse. Oh, nice save by Vince late in the shot clock. So that's one of the things. You see guys come and they're playing D. A D role, which he did play in Boxcars in Orangeville.
Like, but Brandon Slade.
Yeah.
There's another guy who's an offensive star.
All-time stud at Brock.
And Goofa,
Hard pass across. Kluge goes underneath. Drives to the net. He's in the crease.
Last shot on offense was by Johnny Paulus, who hasn't scored a goal for Toronto since their second game. I think he had 3 goals his first 2 games. Hasn't scored since. They would love for him to get something going again.
Pass to the middle, chance for Reinholt, but he missed. It's grabbed by Gilray. Very calm, poised play. There's a guy coming back off injury too, had a something in his hand hurt at the end of the Man Cup. And had to work to get back and be ready to go for the season. Smith steps around the screen, goes down to Billings. Watched closely by Edwards. Gets a shot off, that was a nice play. Rebound comes to Kluge. Thought about shooting, pulls it back out. Good call. Boy, we had 11 goals. 5 goals in the first quarter, 11 in the second, just 1 in the third.
Yeah.
Nothing so far in the fourth. Will this be the one? Kluge fighting through. Oh, no. Nice defense. And the rocker coming. Here comes Domini. Can Spanger catch him? No! Oh, that goal! Scott Domini!
He's definitely becoming a fan favorite because of goals like this. As I said last week, he missed a potential breakaway when he couldn't pick up the ball cleanly, and he was really upset with himself. Scored 2 big goals, big celebration. This is a huge goal too. Watch the dive. I thought he was going to fly into the bar of the net. Luckily, he was able to change his direction at the last second, because that's a lot of speed he's coming at.
And he had to keep going. You know, now, likely on the breakaway.
He could not slow down. No, he couldn't afford to slow down with Spanger right on his backside.
What a great play by Scott Domini. And credit to our producer, Brent Kuzlin, who said, hey, should we have Domini as a player to watch? There's a shot saved by Rose. Maintains that 2-goal lead because he's, you know, providing some scoring. And I said, you can't count on him to score all the time as a transition guy. Maybe we should have.
And you know, again, Toronto really counts on a lot of guys to score the transition goals.
Full stick for Brownell. It may have been tossed aside by Challen Rogers. Buffalo was thinking that could have been a holding the stick call. Ryan Fowler will get it. Oh, sorry, Sean Grenier. Toss it over to the bench as Buffalo goes to the O. Isolation for Smith. Goes far side to Byrne. Watched by Hostrauser, the pick from Kluge, but Hostrauser just battles through it. Help from Edwards. Byrne's going to try the jump dunk. No. If that had
gone in, it was close. For a second, I thought it did.
I did too. Yeah. Rose just stood his ground.
Well, you see teams finding different ways to defend the dunk. Sometimes it's a defender stands in the net as well.
There's a pass to the near side, Palace. He's going to get a pick from Craig. It's a slip. Back to Craig. Great pass, great catch, but not much time to get a shot up.
That was a nice pass. Was that Powell's made that pass?
That was Powell's behind back. Nice, yeah. Spanger with the shot. Comes straight back out to him, and he bounces it to Fraser. Is Spanger staying? No, he's going to go. He'll send a pick on the way and take a chop from Mans, who's back playing defense. There's Kluche. Goes high, has Billings. It's not there. Oh, that's Billings right there. Fraser. Bouncer, Rose had no trouble. Pretty physical defensive play with the ball loose on the floor by Scott Dominey.
Yeah, good nice, play. Nice play. We talked about it earlier, boxing your man out.
Boxing him doesn't always involve putting him on the floor, but here's Reinhold. Speaking of goofy players, terrific Western Mustang. Dawson off the post. It's going to come out to McKay. He scoops it cleanly. Is that early? Nope. No hand up. McKay spins out. Buffalo thought it was. It was very close to the turnover player hustling to the bench.
It really was a smart play by Toronto. Dawson knew.
Just knew him rocking into it.
Couldn't catch him.
Yeah, that's a heads up play to just step into the change box.
Sometimes referees just call that on instinct. It almost looks unfair, you know?
Here's Dawson, all alone off the crossbar. Gilray's got it. That's Arnett's going to the bench.
The second pipe Dawson has hit in the last two plays. This is a 3-on-2.
It's a pick from Minichiello. Spinning out. There's Kluche in the trailer. Gets out of the backside. Jay couldn't quite come up with it.
We've only had two goals in the second half, and Buffalo hasn't scored in over 23 minutes. And I know the Toronto Rock fans are going to be angry at me because that'll just ensure they're going to score in the next few seconds.
They need to get something going. They're down 10-8. The Grizz have passed, and won't beat Buffalo's Toronto as Hellyer. Is that number 200, Buchanan?
I think you're right. I think he came into the game with 197. That's his hat trick goal. Yeah, that should be his 200th career goal. Let's have a look at this monumental goal. Yeah, Dan Dawson, great.
Oh, challenge flag.
Oh, the flag got thrown.
What does he see?
I haven't seen it, but he might be in the crease. That's hard to tell.
I think
it's
the right
so
foot's
fast.
Okay. It's the left one coming down. Does it get in time?
You know, the referees always call it a goal. Unless it's like, unless it's
spoken
absolutely.
Like a true defense,
no, but unless it's in this league because they know that they could challenge, unless it's absolutely blatant, they're going to call it a goal. And I don't blame them. Error on that side.
Yeah. Hey, JT's been pretty sharp on his challenges.
I mentioned on Friday, he's got two challenges in the first 5 minutes of the game, and he won them both.
And I just want to give a quick shout out to Seamus Shanahan. We're asking about the Hellyer goal. And by the time we were finished talking about it, he'd already written out the note. That's his 200th.
Seamus is our stats guy. It's a big day for the Shanahan family here today. Devlin Shanahan,
warm-up.
Number three goalie for Buffalo, and Seamus, our stats guy.
Took about 700 shots in warm-up, I believe.
And my daughter's playing for University of Louisville. Just sent me a text saying they won their first game of the year.
Lovely. So we've got a replay up on the big screen on the Jumbotron. And you're seeing it. Here we go.
Let's see. Let's see this angle. Okay, that one foot didn't go in. Now you can't see the other foot. Now keep in mind, even if he was in the crease, if the videos don't prove it definitively, like that video we just saw, and usually it's the overhead is the one that tells the tale. And that overhead, all we saw was the one foot that definitely wasn't in the crease.
And the other foot was kind of over off the top of the screen.
Yeah.
We'll see it here again.
Let's see what else we have a look at. Okay, this might now here, you know, Buffalo's misfortune there.
That's a good goal.
Yeah, but his foot might have gone in the crease, but the Buffalo player was standing in front of the camera. Oh, let's
Which
see
foot?
This.
The right foot? No, the right
Here's
foot's
another.
Clean. It's clean.
Yeah, that's good. Yeah. That's good.
Shanny, we had the right foot clean right off the bat. It was the left we were looking for. Because it did tick Rose, right? And that slows it down a little bit. Or sorry, tick Vince.
Vince, yeah.
Yeah. Brian Fowler has shared it with everyone. That's a good goal, and it's 11-8.
That was. So now,
Hellyer can celebrate his 200th goal. I'm sure he's not even thinking about that.
No.
Although the
he knows that
audience has just been told.
Announced it. So we've had a little flurry here after not much scoring for a while. Still nothing for Buffalo in 24, 25 minutes now.
That's three goals for Hellyer. Dawson gets another assist. Dawson's got a six-point night.
Dawson is closing rapidly on Josh Sanders
with
908 per second. Dawson taking his time over to Craig. Oh, down to Palace, who wasn't ready. His stick had been tied up, so the ball hit him in the head. Here's McKay.
Now, we saw Buffalo pull Vince earlier last quarter just on a regular play, you know, no delayed play. I wonder how early they might decide to do that if they do that again.
Yeah. Burns spins underneath.
There was a stick check at the last second.
Did Cree get a bit of
him? Yeah, that was Brad Cree.
Fraser got the shot off as he picked up that loose ball. It was late in the 30.
Oh, look at him.
Brad Cree's going to just let the ball run.
Yeah.
Let the clock run. I wouldn't even pick it up yet. Because the 8 second count doesn't start to pick it up. He could still be back there. I've seen Sean Evans do that, where he'll just stand there and he will not pick the ball up until you come and make him do it. Dawson, watched by Harnett, takes a peek behind him. Dawson goes underneath, Sweeting with the slide to help. Nice job taking it away. They switch back. Hard shot by Reinhold. Goes straight out to Hellyer.
Now you watch. You know, Toronto's going to take their time in the 30 every time. You still want to play offense. You still want to go to the net. But no need to rush it if you don't have to.
Hellyer driving on Harnett. Steps around. Shot. That's off the post. Mans picks it up. Another fresh 30 for Toronto. This is worst case scenario for a Buffalo defense full of guys who played Friday night.
Yeah.
Then traveled and then playing a full game here late in the fourth. And now you're getting three possessions in a row for Toronto. There's the pass to Craig. Big save by Vince to bail them out. Oh, dude, Toronto almost got it again. Gilray picks it up and avoids the crease.
Yeah, a couple of good saves by Vince, and you know, a couple times he was saved by the pipe.
It is over 25 minutes now since Buffalo has scored. Six to go in the game. They need to get something rolling. Dane Smith to Billings. He'll fire one. That's wide. Grab there. Is that Hostrazer getting it?
Boy.
Oh, he points to Tommy, who didn't see where it was. And that's going to be a turnover. Goes back to Kevin Brown.
Miscommunication. I think it was the right play, the pass. But I think Dominey, in that case, was just thinking breakaway. You got to think possession first.
Yeah, you can tell Dominey's going to the middle of the floor, but Hostrazer was thinking there's a defender there.
Yeah, he was just making the safe play.
Yeah, throw it into space. Picked up and thrown ahead by Taylor Stewart. Here's a chance for Edwards. Save,
oh,
Vince.
Oh, nice save.
Now, you might wonder, should he take that shot? I think so.
I think I think you got a breakaway 5 minutes ago. You got to take that shot. You can't start passing up those opportunities.
No, that's your MO. Oh, nice save by Rose. Burn had him going the wrong way, but throws the arm out. Here's Jubinville. Now, this one you pull up, and he barely will.
But I've been in games where you see teams almost let you take it to the net because they want that ball back. So they're given the odds, their goalie's going to make a save, and they'd rather get you have that shot with the ball back.
Oh, the odds aren't good with Dan Dawson. It's wide open on top of the crease. Is that four for him today?
I think it's three. Three? Yeah, that's three for Dawson, along with four assists, so a seven-point night so far. And, you know, this Buffalo defense has really worked of late. And how do you like the no-look pass by Hellyer?
So casual, too.
Look where he's looking. He's looking the other place. Dawson just sneaks in and puts that in. And how many posts has Dawson hit in the last few minutes alone?
Right? He could have six or seven.
Yeah.
Remember a couple years ago when Dawson bounced, was in Rochester, bounced to Saskatchewan?
It looked like Dawson was done.
We thought he was done.
Yep.
We were all wrong.
He played for Saskatchewan in the championship series. They lost the game he played. He didn't have a particularly good game, and he didn't play again.
They won healthy scratching games one and three.
Yeah, they won the championship, but I think a lot of people thought that's it for Dan Dawson. They won a championship. He wasn't a big part of it.
And then he had
came back with a great
88
year.
88 points last year, was it? 86?
Oh, yeah. I don't remember the exact number, but a very good comeback season.
J.P. Keeley misses with the shot.
Yeah, And again, Toronto's going to be trying to eat up 30 seconds every day. I'll be shocked if Buffalo doesn't pull their goalie on the next possession.
Yeah. It was 88 points last year for Dawson, by the way.
88 points, not bad.
I was right my first guess.
And Billings had 83 for those guys. And, you know, another comeback story. That was the best comeback story of the year. Was
right?
Dawson's and Billings, yeah.
It was a battle for the comeback player of the year there. There's Fraser to Smith. Spanger coming out as the fifth attacker. He's going to go and set a pick. And another one. Burr goes to the net. Shovel pass. Nobody's there. Jubinville gets it. I think Kluche thought he should keep driving to the net. Burr tossed it back towards him. So far, Vince has stayed in his crease. Minichiello is waving his arms, communicating with Buffalo, with his fellow defenders. That's hard to hear your fellow defenders when you're trying to communicate. Hellyer up to Dawson. Has he got another one in him? He's got a lane. There's a save by Vince. It goes out to Rogers. Fresh 30 Toronto as we approach the final 3 minutes.
And at this point, we see Dane Smith is just staying up the floor.
And as you say
Toronto,
he's
call a timeout?
Out. No, it's Matt Vince has to adjust his helmet.
Oh, okay.
So that will be our media break. So a run for Toronto. They've pulled ahead 12-8 on BR on NLL on BR Live. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan and Ashley Docking. We'll see you in a minute. If you love the NLL, and why wouldn't you? You'll love all the highlights on our social channels. Get the best goals, saves, and action during the games and during the week on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, and NLL.com. And speaking of highlights, let's see the alternate save of the game.
Well, great goaltending from both goalies, but Nick Rose in this second half has not allowed a goal. And that's Kluche, who's beat him early in the game, but he's probably feeling the same frustration as everybody else in his team is in the second half, and that's the alternate save of the game by Nick Rose.
Yeah, I mean, Buffalo got their eighth goal at 10:30 of the second quarter. Dane Smith, or sorry, the eighth goal was Josh Byrne. At 13:14.
It's not like Toronto has dominated since then. It's just that they have, well, both teams have played better defense in the second half. It's just Toronto's been able to pick away.
Buffalo is sending Byrne up the floor now.
Still 17 seconds to go.
Oh, and there's a broken stick for Chalen Rogers. So he's going to head to the bench, and Buffalo will get it. Vince is still
in the crease, yeah.
Here's Gilray. Rips it! Maybe he knew something we didn't.
Yeah. But that's not the goal you're expecting. You know, like, that's a big break for Buffalo because, you know, they're putting all their big guns out there. They're not getting anything. And Gilray, a defensive player, just comes, you know, on a outside shot. Maybe Toronto gave him a little bit too much space to take that shot. And that's where you think, normally you think, wait for the offense, wait for all your guns to get on the floor. But, you know, maybe when you're down by four, you take a chance. And, you know, that turned out to be a smart play by Gilray.
Yeah, down by four with 2:39
He's also got an offensive guy playing defense against him. That was Dan Craig in front of him playing the defense.
Who was just spinning around to try and check him as the shot was departing the stick. So now do we see Vince go? We'll see. Toronto's got the ball for the time being. Burns will run through, but it's an 8-second count.
Oh, boy. And he
might get going to get it in push.
That was a dumb play by Toronto, I believe. That'll be a penalty.
We are going to take a break, our final media break of the game of regulation. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan. It's 12-9. We are back to BR Live's NLL coverage right after this.
It's time for the Geico play of the game, and this was a long time ago with Josh Byrne, who scored a few nice goals, scores a beauty as he just goes Air Jordan, just floats in the air and beats Nick Rose. That actually made the score 3-2. That was when Toronto was up 3-0. Buffalo came back, as we knew they would, to make it a game. I thought Toronto was getting a penalty there, Stamper, but apparently not. When you're called on a turnover, you're supposed to put the ball straight down. Yeah. And I thought Toronto rolled that ball. The whistle went right away, but I guess it was whistle for the timeout.
Yeah. And I think it's called the air burn there.
The air burn, okay. Yeah, I'm aging myself. You know, the Air Jordan.
Now Matt Vince is going to the
bench. Vince is coming.
So Fraser will wait until he gets to the bench to step out. Play is underway. Final 2.5 minutes. Buffalo down by 3 with the ball and the extra attacker. Kluche to Byrne. Gets a pick from Kluche. Flips it to Billings back to Fluche. Great D so far by Toronto. Burn back door, gets away from Small. It's going to be Toronto possession. Jay gets it. I'm sorry, Damon Edwards. Smith with the big check.
Oh, boy.
Oh, what a pass by Damon Edwards.
I'm not sure if that's who he was passing to.
It got there.
Yeah.
I don't know. Hellyer sheds Burn.
Toronto still has their timeout, correct?
Because
you also know if Toronto gets into trouble in a situation, they can call a timeout.
Yeah, they haven't had a successful challenge. There's a shot late in the 30 by Hellyer. It's wide. Vince is walking and now running towards the bench. 1:35 to go. Three goals for the Bandits to make up. Toronto took down the Halifax Thunderbirds last week. Can they do the same to the team tied with Halifax, the Buffalo Bandits? They may well, because David Brock has picked that one up, and there's nobody between him and that empty net. Second goal for David Brock. That one's a lot easier.
Yes. With a minute 17 to go, expanding that lead to four goals again, I'd say that this one is in the books, but seen stranger things happen.
Yeah. Well, we saw two Toronto goals in 25 seconds earlier in the game. Yep. At that pace, Buffalo could score four and have the full possession left.
Yeah, it's always scarier, too, when you have a dominant faceoff man at this point. I know we have the argument of how important it is to have a dominant faceoff man or not, but at points like this, you like having a guy who can win every draw.
Brad Cree comes out to take that one. Is Gustafson's probably the majority?
Yeah, Toronto's been the better team in the faceoffs, but it's been just over a little bit better than 50-50.
Yeah, that's the sixth faceoff Cree has taken. That's four of them he's won. That's through the crease. Hellyer can't play it. Or sorry, Craig can't play it. And Buffalo will come. Vince is looking to the bench. Not going. 48 seconds to go. Fraser.
I think they've decided that
that's it.
It's done, yeah.
Billings goes to the net, spins, back up top to Keeley. J.P. Keeley, love one. Top rows off of Brock, and he'll lob it ahead to Rogers.
Well, you got to think of how tired this Buffalo team is. Yeah. They played Friday night, traveled across the country.
And so
this was a pretty good game, too.
So often that's when you really see the fatigue kick in, right? It's in the third and fourth quarter. A team has trouble matching the other team's intensity after that travel. I don't think Buffalo wants to make excuses. I don't think anybody wants to make excuses for them, but that definitely has to be a factor.
Oh, yeah, yeah, for sure.
Shot clock about to expire. Rogers will lob it down into the end. Ian McKay is going to catch that ball. There's a penalty coming.
Well, the North is just tightened up.
And Kyle Kropman saying, hang on, don't blow the buzzer. He was blowing his whistle instead. I think is it delay a game?
I'm not sure yet, but I don't think it's going to make a difference in the outcome here.
Channy, it has been a delight to be back on the mic with you.
Oh, it was a great game. You picked a great game to do, Stamper.
Yeah, I thought this would be a good one. Andy, go to Florida. Enjoy yourself. Everyone looking forward to having you back next week, of course.
So Halifax now 6-1 in first, Buffalo 6-2, and Toronto 5-2.
They're reviewing. Ryan Fowler's not in. Just checking how long, I guess, should be on the clock. I think it's about 5 seconds. But I mean,
just round it up. Who cares at this point?
So the updated standings, the Bandits fall to 6-2. The Rock get within a half game of Buffalo and stay alive in the season series between the two teams. That's huge.
That is absolutely huge. They'll play each other one more time. I believe the third time's in Toronto again.
So a great finish for the Rock. 5-1 in the second half. They outscored Buffalo to take the win. And Shanny, that's a great effort by Toronto, who still missing a bunch of players and just next man up. They're playing great.
We didn't even really talk about that. Yeah. The fact that they're missing, Jones and Schreiber, that's a 2 weeks in a row, big efforts, missing some key guys.
Harris and others. We're going to take a break and we'll be back with NLL action on BR Live. I'm Stephen Stamp with Brian Shanahan and Ashley Docking. Thanks for being with us. We're not done. Come on back.
to the broadcast. I am standing here with Rob Hellyer, and I was just saying to him, we have to stop meeting like this, because earlier in the season, 500 points, now 200th goal. So I do want to start there. What does hitting these kind of milestones mean to you?
I think it means I've played with a lot of great players over my career. I've had a lot, you know, the great ability to, like, you know, play with the guys that, you know, can find me off ball, and I'm lucky enough to put them in the net. So it's a great win, and we're going to celebrate tonight.
Yeah, big win against Buffalo, whom you guys only scored 8 goals against before. Things were a little bit more free-flowing in this one. What did you see that was different, or what was different in your execution to give you guys a chance to score a little bit more than last time?
I thought we had a lot of good chances down there, but tonight we just put them in the net. We made a lot more of our chances count, but we found a couple weak spots in their game that we could exploit, and we took advantage of that.
So I think it's bobblehead night next week, and it's your face. We're going to show everyone in a second. Do you think the likeness is there?
I think they did a pretty good job. Made me look good.
All right. Thanks so much, and congrats.
Thank you.
I'm going to bring you over here, Alex. You want to look at the board? I want to show you the bobblehead. Can you take a look? Down there, bobblehead night for Rob Hellyer, Saturday, February 15th. Vancouver's in town, guys.
All right, thanks, Ashley, and thanks, Alex Frazzo, for getting the shot of the Rob Hellyer bobblehead. Each team had 8 goals in the first half, Shanny. It was a very different story in the second half.
Yeah, and Toronto Rock really had to love that second half. They pretty much shut out Buffalo except for one late goal, but we're going to show you some highlights from that half. And it started out by David Brock. Not your typical transition goal and not your typical goal scorer. Just steps back in the transition, takes an outside shot to score. That gave Toronto a 1-goal lead. Watch this goal by Dominic. Again, the transition, quite different from the last one. All kinds of speed as his momentum takes him right in the boards. It's 10-8 for the Toronto Rock. Dan Dawson finds Hellyer for Hellyer's 3rd goal of the game. And then Dawson's, they're going to return to favor to each other right here. Hellyer to Dawson, and that put him up 12-8. We're going to see a late goal by Buffalo. We thought this pulls it within 3. We thought we were going to get a push, but Brock scores another empty net goal to give Toronto the 4-goal, 13-9 win. Another huge victory. That's 2 weeks in a row against very tough opponents, very tough games, and excellent wins by the Toronto Rock.
And it's early in the season still. We're getting towards the midway point for these teams, but important wins for Toronto to get because, as we said, two teams from the north go straight into the playoffs, and Toronto was on the outside looking in of that. They still are slightly, but they have closed it up by winning this game against the Buffalo Bandits. Very exciting for me to be here today. Thanks so much, Shanny. And
good everyone, to have you here, Stamper.
Everyone on the crew, thanks a lot for Brian Shanahan and Ashley Docking and everyone here at Scotiabank Arena. I'm Stephen Stamp. Thanks for being with us for NLL on BR Live. We'll see you next time.